It is the Sherwin-Williams CHL NHL Top Prospects Game.
It definitely helped me as a player going into the draft and helped my stuff.
Konechny scores again!
It's the best draft eligibles against, you know, the best draft eligible. Up to 300 scouts at the game. I mean, who knows what could happen.
I'm excited to be here. It should be really fun. There's a lot of good players here and that much skill on the ice, you know, should make for a fun game.
It's just a huge honor to get to play in the game.
Here's a player that is going to garner a little bit of attention over the next few months.
It's a big game with lots of eyes on us. Obviously, there's a little bit of nerves, but mostly excitement.
Ellis, last line of defense, stops him.
It's definitely exciting. I mean, I watched my brother play 2 years ago.
Ryan Suzuki scores!
We're playing against the top players in Canada. It's definitely going to be fun.
Byram's going to take it coast to coast on a backhand, scores!
We kind of grew up as a kid watching it and seeing all these guys gone through it, and then they hit the draft, and now they're in the NHL being successful.
What a play by Kirby Dach!
Just look at it as a stepping stone towards where I want to go, and it's just a huge honor and privilege to be here.
Let's take the next 2 to 3 hours and let these future NHL players entertain us in one of the biggest games of their young careers.
Alberta, home to oil, grain, and cattle production, but from the Rustlers to the Rebels, hockey defines this culture. And tonight it's the home of the Sherwin-Williams CHL NHL Top Prospects Game. 40 hand-picked players. They look to impress scouts and GMs ahead of this summer's NHL entry draft. It also marks an important personal step in each player's hockey journey. Dylan Cousins, he was born and raised in Whitehorse, Yukon. At 14, he came to the realization, if I want to be my best, I'm going to need to leave home. Well, tonight he leads the best as he captains Team Cherry. From the third-ranked North American skater to the second, Kirby Dach leads Team Orr as he gets set to play on this stage in his home province. Well, as he says, sure, there are nerves, but the more fun you have, the better you'll play. Isn't that true? Welcome into the Centrium, home of the Red Deer Rebels and the 2001 Memorial Cup champs. I'm Carolyn Cameron. And would you look at that, Colby Armstrong, one of those 2001 champs. I'm shocked we could get you from all the fans. He was signing tons of autographs. You're the man here. It's true.
I had some good years here. I had some good times here. Yeah.
And, of course, Todd Warner, Windsor Spitfire, Kitchener Ranger, and I've already mentioned Cousins and Dach. And you look at these two, and they're so close in terms of comparables. What do you make of the comparison?
Well, the first thing I notice when talking about Kirby Dach, Saskatoon Blade, high-end player, is his body. He's 6'4", 200 pounds, and you look at that and you think NHL ready. And then you look at what he's able to bring. Offensively, a great playmaker, pass-first type of player, models his game likely after a guy like Ryan Getzlaff with the way he sees the ice, makes plays, and uses his body. A guy that can hurt you in a lot of different ways by stripping pucks, a guy on his back, or making things happen on his own.
And if Dach is the most NHL-ready player, I think Cousins might have the most upside in terms of what he could be 4, 5, 6 years down the road. At 180 pounds, he moves like a pro already. Great skater, can do things in traffic and at high speeds that are great for his age. And if this game turns into a muckers game, Colby, and is played along the boards and down low, I think that favors Dach's game. But if it's a fast game, it's a pace game, becomes a track meet, I think that favors Cousins.
Let's look now at Peyton Krebs in Kootenay, because this is a team that's struggling offensively, but he's averaging over a point per game. You're impressed with his play, especially considering he's 5'11".
Yeah, a smaller type player, which is normal now. We see a lot of smaller players, and we have been. But I'm looking at a guy that's playing on a team with 10 wins this year in the Kootenay Ice. Their second worst team in the Western Hockey League, and he's a guy that carries this team. He plays in a ton of different situations. He gets a lot of ice time. He powers it when the puck's on his stick and making things happen and dictating the play out on the ice. And for me, playing on a team that's second worst in the Western Hockey League, gets a chance to play with top players here in this game. And hey, when you get that opportunity, you want to shine on a big stage and say, hey, I'm ranked number 8. Where can I move up a little bit if you can see what I can do out here?
And he'll play with two American guys, Nick Robertson and Artur Kaliev. And Kaliev, for me, might be the purest sniper in this game. So two good American players who played together in the past will play with Krebs. He'll get to play with good players today.
Well, as Dach said, I think we're in for an exciting and fun evening. So let's go rinkside now and check in with Rob Faltz.
Carolyn, thank you very much. For draft eligible players, this is the invitation they want. Just think of the numbers over the years. It's staggering. This is the 24th year of this event. It was first held in 1996. So the number of players that have gone through the top prospects, actually quite staggering. So year 24 for the top prospects game, and there are 34 CHL teams represented, 12 from the Western Hockey League, 12 from the Ontario Hockey League, and 10 from the Quebec Major Junior Hockey League. And it truly is international now. 9 countries are represented, 26 from Canada, 4 from the United States, and 4 from Russia. A little bit of trivia for you. In 1996, who were the captains? Well, it was Chris Phillips and Josh Green. Well, two men who are certainly tops are ready to call it. Let's go upstairs to RJ Broadhead and Sam Cosentino.
Thank you very much, Rob. 40 players. They all have a great story. We'll try to tell them all tonight. But one of the tremendous stories is that of Brett Leeson. Third year in the Western Hockey League with Prince Albert this year. He has 31 goals in 39 games. He had never had more than 16 goals in a season. And he's 19. Most of the other players are 17 or 18. So why all of a sudden has he emerged as one of the top players?
Well, it's confidence gained through opportunity. Let's rewind the tape and go back to last year. With the Tri-City Americans, one assist in the first 12 games. They were a deep team. They had the opportunity to move him. They moved him to Prince Albert. The head coach there, Mark Hapscheid, gave him opportunity. In the final 54 games of the year, he had 32 points and realized, hey, I can play with these guys. So he went to work in the offseason. He improved his lower body strength. The skating ability really started to come along. He started this year in a 30-game point streak. All of a sudden, people are talking about him. Hockey Canada says, hey, you need to play on our team at the World Juniors. And the story doesn't have a good ending yet, but it will come June.
No question about it. Last year at this event, Ty Dellandrea had 2 goals in 20 seconds. That set a record. Evan Bouchard, 4 assists. That set a record for defensemen. And they both went in the first round in the draft. So it will be fun to see who shines tonight, Carolyn.
RJ, Sam, thanks very much. Looking forward to it. All these prospects, their love of the game began when they were a child. And that was the same for Ron McLean and his love of Canada. Because he and his family, his dad Ron was in the Air Force, they moved around a lot. And in the early 70s, they moved here to Red Deer, Alberta. This is where Ron spent his formative years. Grade 7 to 12, he was playing hockey at Grandview Gardens. He began his broadcasting career at CKRD. He watched all of the Sutters play. And tonight, with Brent Sutter's help, he is the head coach of Don Cherry's team up against Kelly Rudy for Team Orr. So let's go into the room and see how the two coaches are faring.
Scouts tonight, not going to change their mind about you one iota. They're going to be enjoying their work. They already had faith in you to bring you to my hometown of Red Deer, Alberta. So you can just go out there without any fear whatsoever and do the thing that you've been doing for 17, 18 years. And the last thing I'll say is the most important thing, and I told you that Monday night, is I have to go back and face Don Cherry in the coach's corner. So for heaven's sakes, let's win. Thing.
Go out there and just react. So have fun, boys. I know you guys will do great. We have 2 outstanding goaltenders. Today we're going to start with Hunter Jones. He's going to be great. Yeah. Robin, who's starting on D?
Jake and Lassie, start us off.
Mark, starting forwards.
And we got Pelche, Leeson, and Dach.
Let's go, boys. Knock it out of the park. Have some fun. Come on!
When I spoke to Kelly and Ron, they both said they're nervous for this game. So the prospects are not alone. Let's go to the PA announcer, Kevin Watson.
Was inducted into the Alberta Sports Hall of Fame in 1996 and received a star in Canada's Walk of Fame in 2016. Please welcome Red Deer native, Rogers Hometown Hockey, and Sportsnet's Hockey Night in Canada host, Ron McLean. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing Team Orr. From the Peterborough Petes, number 29, Hunter Jones. From the Rimouski Oceanic, number 92, Colton Ellis. From the Kelowna Rockets, number 2, Lassie Thompson. From the Kelowna Rockets, number 6, Caden Korzak. From the Chicoutimi Sauganee, number 8, Artemi Kuznaev. From the Ottawa 67s, number 9, Graham Clark. From the London Knights, number 10, Connor McMichael. From the Moncton Wildcats, number 11, Jacob Pelche. From the Charlottetown Islanders, number 14, Nikita Alexandrov. From the Flint Firebirds, number 18, Vladislav Kolianchunuk. From the Sault Ste. Marie Greyhounds, number 19, Joe Carroll. From the Prince Albert Raiders, number 20, Brett Leeson. From the Seattle Thunderbirds, number 24, Jake Lee. From the Niagara Ice Dogs, number 26, Philip Tomasino. From the Ottawa 67s, Nikita, number 28, Nikita Ohachuk. From the Tri-City Americans, number 34, Sasha Mutella. From the Edmonton Oil Kings, number 42, Josh Williams. From the Barrie Colts, number 61, Ryan Suzuki. From the London Knights, number 70, Matvei Guskov. And from the Saskatoon Blades, number 77, team captain Kirby Dach. Now introducing Team Cherry from the Minnesota Tigers, number 30, Mats Sogard. From the Prince George Cougars, number 35, Taylor Gauthier. From the Bay Como Drakkar, number 9, Nathan Legere. From your Red Deer Rebels, number 13, Oleg Zaitsev. From the Peterborough Petes, number 16, Nick Robertson. From the Kootenay Ice, number 19, Peyton Krebs. From the Edmonton Oil Kings, number 22, Matthew Robertson. From the Lethbridge Hurricanes, number 24, team captain Dylan Cousins. From the Kelowna Rockets, number 29, Nolan Foote. From the Hamilton Bulldogs, number 34, Arthur Kaliev. From the Sarnia Sting, number 39, Jameson Reese. From the Kitchener Rangers, number 43, Michael Vukojevic. From the Vancouver Giants, number 44, Bowen Byron. From the Mississauga Steelheads, number 48, Thomas Harley. From the Halifax Mooseheads, number 50, Raphael Lavoie. From the Blainville Wabrand Armada, number 58, Samuel Bolduc. From the Shawinigan Cataract, number 65, Valentin Nussbaumer. From the Kingston Frontenacs, number 68, Billy Constantino. From the St. John Sea Dogs, number 88, Maxim Chaikevich. And from the Sherbrooke Phoenix, number 92, Samuel Poulin. Now please welcome our official party for tonight's ceremonial puck drop. Representing the Canadian Hockey League and Western Hockey League, please welcome CHL Vice President and WHL Commissioner Ron Robison. Representing the City of Red Deer, please welcome Mayor Tara Veer. And representing title partner Sherwin-Williams, please welcome District Manager from Southern Alberta, Jeff Miller. Would Kirby Dach from Team Orr and Dylan Cousins from Team Cherry please skate to center ice for a ceremonial puck drop? We now please rise if you are able to remove your hats for the American and Canadian national anthems performed by Brent LaBrosse and Carolyn Menard.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight. Oh, the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave.
Oh, Canada, our home and native land, true patriot love in all of us command. Car ton bras s'est porté l'épée, il s'est porté la croix. Ton histoire est une épopée des plus brillants exploits. God keep our land glorious and free. Oh, Canada, we stand on guard for thee. Oh, Canada, we stand on guard for them.
And with that, it's time to play. And Colby, you've been in this position as a top prospect. You've been on the ice. How do the players feel at this moment?
Well, when we sat down with a bunch of players yesterday and talking to them, they all mentioned how anxious they were and how a little bit of nerves that they had. But they said that's a good thing. It's something you can feed off. If you're not nervous, you're not ready. And these guys on this stage in this venue, I think it's a good thing to have that little nervous energy, Todd.
And honestly, given what they've been through the last 72 hours, poked, prodded, interviewed, tested, they're probably thrilled to just puck drop and get playing. I would be.
Dylan Cousins, he had to go straight from the airport and quickly head to practice, and now he's standing by with Rob Faltz.
Dylan, as you get ready for this game, tell me about emotions right now. There's a lot of people watching, scouts and GMs.
Yeah, obviously we're all super excited, but a little nervous too, but we can't think about it too much. It's the same game we've been playing our whole life, so just go out there one shift at a time and things will work out.
Game planning something like this against basically an all-star team of guys who are draft eligible, what do you want to do in your own game?
I just want to focus on what I do best, use my speed, win my one-on-one battles, and hopefully things will work out for me.
Enjoy the experience.
Thank you. I will.
Dylan Cousins is ready to go. Team Cherry ready to go, facing Team Orr in the Sherwin-Williams CHL-NHL Top Prospects game. With the call, RJ Broadhead and Sam Cosentino.
Thank you, Rob. It should be a fantastic evening here in Red Deer. In goal for Team Cherry, it's Mads Søgaard. He's from Denmark, and NHL teams, they want big goalies. It doesn't get any bigger than Mads. He's 6'7", plays with the Medicine Hat Tigers, and he is among the WHL leaders this season. In goal for Team Orr, it's Hunter Jones, plays with the Peterborough Petes. He's from Brantford. Had a shutout in his first game of the season, tied for the most OHL appearances. He's faced the most shots, he's made the most saves, and he's got 21 wins, one of six OHL goaltenders to get to that mark. All these players are trying to make their mark. We've talked about the two top-ranked players, and Sam, how about Bowen Byram, the top-ranked defenseman among North American skaters?
He checks in at number four overall. Here's a guy who leads all the CHL in terms of defenseman scoring with 16 goals, playing for Mike Dick and Jamie Hewitt in the Vancouver Giants. He'll be a fun one to watch, loaded with confidence. Got some NHL bloodlines. His dad, Sean, played a handful of games in the National Hockey League.
These players spent their lives dreaming about being in the NHL, and that day will be soon for some of these players. It's a big step toward that dream, and to be here is by invitation only. The Sherwin-Williams CHL-NHL Top Prospects game is underway, and Team Cherry goes on the attack immediately. There's their captain, Dylan Cousins, Lethbridge Hurricane. He's the number three ranked skater among North American players. Raphael Lavoie, he's the top Quebec Major Junior Hockey League ranked player in this event, and he got the puck to the net, and Hunter Jones gets an early touch, and he hangs on.
Good size and strength from the length of Bois to get a shot on goal. And right off the hop, Who are we talking about? Number two and number three. And you thought Dylan Cousins might come into this thing with a bit of edge and try and prove something that he should be higher rated than Kirby Dach. Well, the two, a little scrum right off the draw. You heard the guys talk about it in the panel before the game.
Thomas Harley took the shot. That's wide of the net. Joe Carroll holds it along the boards. Could not get it out. Here's Peyton Krebs. Kootenay ice. Throws it back to the blue line. Nick Robertson, a long low shot in front of the goal. That was Arthur Kaliev, and we know he can score 30 goals plus in his two seasons with the Hamilton Bulldogs. He's open, he shoots, and he scores right on cue. Arthur Kaliev, 1-0 Team Cherry.
Not to call myself a genius, but about 10 minutes ago in the booth, what did I say? Artie's gonna get one here tonight. And the reason is he's got great chemistry with Nick Robertson. The two have played together at the Hlinka tryouts for Team USA. They played together at the Hlinka Gretzky Cup. They played together at the U.S. Top Prospects Game in September. Robertson knew exactly where Kaliev was going to be. When you have a snipe show like Kaliev waiting in the wings and there's no one between he and the goalie, light it. Light the lamp. It's in. Kaliev, with 33 goals this year for the Hamilton Bulldogs, gets Team Cherry on the board early.
Those 31 goals as a 16-year-old, a lot of people were wondering how he'd follow it up. Well, he's already surpassed it. Looks good here, less than a minute in. Team Cherry with the lead, and they're buzzing again. Big hit thrown by Nikita Hutchuk. Not a surprise for Ottawa 67's fans. They know he can be a physical presence. Huck bouncing around. It got to Connor McMichael. Matvei Guskov, his London Knights teammate, couldn't get the puck back to him. Samuel Poulin. Plays with a Sherbrooke Phoenix, trying to track down Vladislav Poliachonik. He's a Flint Firebird. Here's Guskov. He came in over the line, but Graham Clark was a stride ahead.
Guskov with that one extra step creates the offside. Kelly, have all smiles on the bench for Team Cherry, and why wouldn't you be? Good work here by Robertson. He realizes the lane isn't there, but once he spins, the lane opens up on the back end, is able to get it across the ice to Kaliev, and oh yeah, Ron's appreciating that effort from the Hamilton Bulldog early on.
He knows Don could be in a good mood when he sees him next. He leads Team Cherry here to a victory. Race for the puck. There's Jameson Reese, who wins the race. But he made that move at the blue line, and this time it's Team Cherry that's offside.
Well, Jameson Reese of the Sarnia Sting, happy to be playing hockey once again, missed a significant amount of time with a punctured kidney. He's wearing that flak jacket around the kidney area. It was driving him nuts to be at home, but he took the opportunity to sit back, watch games, learn what the good players are doing, keep and paying attention to what's happening in the faceoff circle, and he thinks he'll benefit from that experience of sitting up.
Phil Tomasino, the Niagara Ice Stars. Slow start to the season for Tomasino, but he's been red hot in his last 20 or so games. Billy Constantino, he plays with the Kingston Frontenacs. Close to Cosentino. A couple of letters different. Here's Jameson Reese. He's doing it all himself. Tried to center it to Valentin Nestor. Team Orr was able to get it just as far as the line, and Constantino waits until Nathan Legare was open. He was at the end of a shift, so he set it down low. Cousins was checked deep in the Team Orr end. Nikita Alexandrov up to Sasha Mukala, who plays with the Tri-City Americans. Cousins drops it off for LeBlanc. Michael Vukojevic, kitchen ranger defenseman. Came back, he had to take a hit to make the play, and now LeBlanc speeds through center ice for Team Cherry. This is a big line for the team in red. Nolan Foote, he's number 29. LeBlanc and Cousins, they both got great size. Kirby Dach, top-ranked player in this game. He saw Leeson heading to the net, and that's a pretty good bet to get it in his area. That one was just out of his reach, though. Nolan Foote taken care of along the boards by Caden Korzak of the Kelowna Rockets. That's number six who has Nolan Foote all tied up. So those two Kelowna Rockets teammates, pretty good early battle between those two. Krebs with a shot. It's off a stick. Vukojevic keeps it in. Decides to pass to Krebs. Comes out from behind the net, looking to the front of the goal the whole time. And fresh off the bench, Thomas Harley of the Mississauga Steelheads missed the net. Harley's an interesting story, really not even on the radar. Now he comes into this event as the top-ranked OHL player.
Number nine.
Good move by Nick Robertson. He set up that first goal, and he stick-handed long enough to get a shot through, forced Hunter Jones, his Peterborough teammate, into a big save. Team Orr has spent a lot of the first 4 minutes defending.
Team Cherry with a big burst of energy and obviously taking the momentum from that first goal by Kaliev early on.
Peyton Krebs, pass was in his skates. Polyachonik tried to step up on him. Josh Williams takes the puck away. Williams started the year with Medicine Hat. He was traded to the Edmonton Oil Kings. Back at the blue line, another Oil King, Robertson. His pass across to Samuel Bolduc. He was wide of the goal. And now Team Orr able to get it to center. Williams finds Polyachonik. The Flint Firebird defenseman. All they did was dump it in, and Nick Robertson trying to stick handle away from trouble. Puck came in front of the Team Cherry net, but nobody was there for Team Orr. And the defenseman of Blainville, Boisbriand, Samuel Bolduc, who lit up the off-ice training yesterday. He was the top performer, and he is a fitness nut. It's pretty interesting. He's good friends with Nathan Legare. They were the two top finishers in the off-ice testing. And they were competing against each other, so that's pretty good when you have that competition to make you better.
Yeah, and they have guys in the offseason. They work out some guy by the name of Alexi Lafreniere. Samuel Poulin, also part of that group, so they push each other all summer long.
Yeah, book your calendar now for next year's event. You'll want to see it. Alexi Lafreniere will be in this game. And there's a penalty. First one of the game, and it's a tripping call. It's going to go against Team Cherry, so Team Orr has a chance to get this game even.
Yeah, perfect way to change momentum here because of the penalty call. Then now Team Orr gets that opportunity behind the net. Kovic with the trip up behind the net, and now Team Orr will be able to go on the power play. There's Brent Sutter saying, here's the guys I want out here for my penalty kill. Make sure there's always a centerman out there.
That's a challenge, too, in this event.
Yeah.
Coaches not super familiar with the players and with their respective club teams. Maybe they don't kill penalties, some of these players, but they're going to roll lines. They're going to be put in positions where they'll be tested. Let's see what happens here. Power play, Team Orr. This is Artemi Kanayazev. Plays with Shakutami. Kirby Dach does not shoot. Circles back. Gets it to Kanayazev. He has the most points among Q defensemen in this event. Bouncing around in front of the goal, big Mad Sogard keeps it out of his net. Dan Valentin Nussbaumer of the Shawinigan Cataracts sends it down the ice, and he's off to the bench for a change.
Really good look by Dach to the middle of the ice and an opportunity for Team Orr with Pelche in front of the net.
Here's Kanayazev. He'll drop it back. This is Lassie Thompson. He's from Finland, plays with the Kelowna Rockets. Kirby Dach, Saskatoon Blades leading scorer, trying to control the puck along the blue line and moved it deep, and Thomas Harley wasted no time getting that down the ice. In the first minute of Team Orr's power play is gone. They managed one shot so far. Vladislav Polyachonik circles back behind his net. He'll bring it up ice, drop it back. Ryan Suzuki had to play it off the board. That pass was in a skate, and now Team Cherry gets it again. Team Orr can't get set up on the power play, and time's running out. They've managed one shot so far. That was earlier on this power play. That's in the game. They've been outshot 4-1, outscored 1-0. Graham Clark falls, got up in a hurry. He knew that could be trouble. Pucks rolled in on Hunter Jones. He wanted to leave it for Suzuki, but that's another challenge in these types of games. You're so used to your team and defensemen and players, they've got that communication with the goaltender. No problem. Team Orr was on a power play. They're in the offensive zone now. Williams back to the blue line. Jake Lee takes a shot. That hits Williams in front of the net. Bolduc, you know he's strong, finishing first in the off-ice testing through a big hit down there on Williams. Hard battle along the boards. Bolduc has found it and able to advance the puck. The penalty was killed very well by Team Cherry. Team Orr got just the one shot on goal. Now back to 5-on-5. Thompson stick handling through center ice as a defenseman. He's got Adam Foote as his head coach in Kelowna. That's a pretty nice luxury to have. One goal so far in the game, and Arthur Kaliev has it for Team Cherry.
Arthur Kaliev of the Hamilton Bulldogs had the opportunity to play in the Memorial Cup last year. Had 31 goals as a 16-year-old, 33 more this year. What makes him such a dangerous player? look at his ability to take the puck to the net with size, better skating ability than I think people thought, and he also has a bomb of a shot. The release is excellent, the accuracy is good, and when he gets in tight, forget it. He's going to the top of the net. Here's an example of that fine work in this game so far. Robertson right on his tape. That is a beautiful, beautiful, highly skilled play by Robertson. And you know, if he gets it to Kaliev, he was going to finish, and he did.
That was early, just 56 seconds into the game. Team Cherry also has killed off a penalty. And they've only allowed Team Orr one shot. So big Mads Søgaard, he wants to showcase his stuff in goal, but he also wants his team to lead. So it's a bit of a predicament for him. Puck bouncing around in Team Orr's aim. Sasha Mutala takes it to the corner. Samuel Poulin, he dug it out of there. Maxime Kankovic. He leads the St. John's Sea Dogs in scoring. There he is, number 88. Couldn't poke that puck loose. Tomasino, Zaitsev, they were locked up, and Mutala comes up with a puck, looking for some open ice. Kajkovic tracks him down and bumps him along the boards. Søgaard comes out to play it. He says he loves playing the puck, works on it all the time. It's something he really likes to do, and with that trapezoid back there, a lot of the young goaltenders have gone away from playing the puck, so it's just another asset that Søgaard has.
Yeah, it's a huge asset too, especially when you're a guy as big as he is. If you have good skating ability, you can get out of the net, you can cut off a lot of plays, a lot of those hard rings, and you can be an outlet to your defenseman and act as that third defenseman. So Søgaard there, very easily out of the net. He's already in position to play the puck. He looked up before he got out there to know he could bring it around the far side.
Puck stolen by Nathan Legare. Snaps a shot at Hunter Jones. That's a good save for him. Legare is the leading goal scorer at this event. He has 34 with Bay Coleman. And he and his teammate Ivan Cenkovic in Bay Como, they've been 1-2 in team scoring. Legare finishing second in the fitness testing. Here's Connor McMichael. Cutting through the middle. No shot again for Team Orr, and they're sent back to retrieve it. This is Caden Korzak from Yorkton, Saskatchewan. Only player from Saskatchewan in this event. Connor McMichael, Ajax, Ontario. 27 goals with the London Knights. He was part of that Robert Thomas trade last year, and the Knights are happy to have him now. Dylan Cousins. By the way, he was the top skater in the testing yesterday, and look at him go. Stick handling around in the Team Orr end. The captain of Team Cherry was hit hard by Nikita Ohotyuk. It won't take long for Team Cherry to figure out number 28 on Team Orr will hit anything that's near him. Long shot in on Søgaard. He knocks it down, keeps things going. Bolduc, there's a nice move for the Armada defenseman. He's from Laval, looks at the net. Tied with Gnaizev for most points among QMJHL defensemen here at this Sherwin-Williams Top Prospects game. Brent Leeson steals it, and he had Peltier with him, and the whistle went because of a penalty. So bad luck for Team Orr. They're going to be shorthanded. We'll take a break. Team Cherry will have a chance to add to their lead on the power play next.
Working with Brent Sutter and Team Cherry is Dave Hunter. Dave, former Sudbury Wolves player, would you have liked this opportunity in this kind of game?
It would have been a great time to have this. It's great to see these young players playing together and showcasing, and you know the Team Cherry's got to win this game. You know, Rob, that.
Well, I know that because Ron's already mentioned that. Grapes, give you any coaching advice before you took this job?
Well, I wore plaid to do the two practices, as you saw. That was the only advice he gave me. It was a little fashion tip. And he taught me, Rob, that if I was doing anything important, I should talk to a card over. But honest to God, a dream defense, right? Bobby Orr, Don Cherry, two defensemen. Would love to have these six going for him.
Greg, let's talk about Don right now. Hold on.
Great, guys. Send her love. Yeah. Cindy's here. She sends hers too.
Well, Ron, Dave, Brent, they'll be happy because they're going to the power play again.
Yeah, Vladislav Kolyachonik of the Flint Firebirds with the hooking infraction on Matthew Robertson.
So already 1-0 for Team Cherry. Their first chance on the power play. And here's the high-scoring defenseman, Bowen Byram. He passes to Nick Robertson, and this is Krebs. Right back to Byram. Billy Constantino. Byram's open. He's at a game where he had 5 points. He can rack up the points. No question about that. Nick Robertson looking at the net. Goes cross ice. That was tipped. So the puck comes out, and that will send Constantino back.
Yeah, Robertson was looking for Kaliev once again. Korzak was wise to it, though. Got a stick on it to deflect it out of the zone.
Korzak gets the puck over to Lassie Thompson. Kelowna Rockets defenseman doing a good job on the penalty kill. The two of them get the puck down the ice.
Yeah, interesting start with two right-handed defensemen out there to get things going in the PK.
Korzak was at the tail end. He got himself a change, so Jake Lee has come out. Almost a minute gone in this power play. Robertson drops it off behind the net, and here is Byram. He's fifth in WHL defenseman scoring with 43 points. Passes over to Constantino, who's the Kingston Frontenacs defenseman leading scorer. Byram with some open ice. Back to Constantino. They're passing it around well. They got a shot, too. And it was stopped by Hunter Jones, and he found it before any of the Team Cherry players on the doorstep could get to it.
Oleg Zaitsev of the Red Deer Rebels, a little frustration in front of the net as he gets into a post-whistle scrum. On the left side of your screen, he's wide open, and Byram doesn't see him, and there's Oleg Zaitsev with a stick in the air. The puck didn't get to him, but he tried to get a tip on it later on before Jones, Hunter Jones of the Peterborough Petes, covered it up.
Thomas Harley, he can generate some offense from the blue line. He's fifth in OHL defenseman scoring. He's got the puck now. Creeps a little closer to the net, decides to pass. Shot comes from Michael Bukoyevich, and Samuel Poulin puts it in. The puck sat there for him. Poulin makes it 2-0 Team Cherry.
Samuel Poulin comes from those great NHL bloodlines. His father, Patrick, a longtime NHL player with over 700 games in the books. And it's the shot from the Kitchener defenseman, Bukoyevich, that causes Hunter Jones trouble. Why? It's because Poulin is in front of the net. He's taking the eyes of Hunter Jones away. Jones has to try and deke and dive around him, and that doesn't allow him to get a clean look on the save. That forces the rebound. Poulin spins around and does a great job picking up the rebound, getting inside position to make it 2-0.
Brett Leeson's out there right now, and he's making things difficult for Thomas Harley, who was trying to skate away. And Leeson's one of those players that when the going gets tough, he gets going. 73 points, really a remarkable season for Leeson. He's got the puck at the blue line. Long shot, that just missed. His Prince Albert Raiders, number one ranked in the CHL, just picked up their 40th win last night. Only team in the CHL with that many. Another shot in on Mads Sogard. He's faced a couple, but he's made it look pretty easy so far.
Well, there's Poulin, the goal scorer. He does such a good job in front of the net here. Look at Hunter Jones. He's got to go to his left. He's got to go to his right. And the problem with this particular shot, why he can't save it, his head is on the left side. The shot goes to the right side. That's why he can't get it clean. And Poulin does such a great job being hard on the puck in front of the net, burying it to that far post.
Such an interesting draft for so many of these players. Samuel Poulin, he's been excellent for Sherbrooke, and every time we've seen him, whether it be the CIBC Canada Russia series or with Sherbrooke, he has been outstanding. Here he gets a goal. Timor trying to get things going. Centering pass by Williams, intercepted by Nussbaumer, and Legare skates it to center, dumps it in. Right on the heels of Kolia Chonik was Nussbaumer. Legare dug it loose. Here's Reese. A great toe drag. Got right to the front of the net and forced Jones into another great save. Four Team Orr players come in over the line. Vladislav Kolyachonik tried the shot. That was blocked by Nussbaumer and a group of Team Cherry players. They're desperate to get to the bench. They were tired. They were haggard. They'd been out there a while, created a couple of chances. Constantino trying to get away from Tomasino. They were teammates in Niagara, and Constantino, he got traded to Kingston as part of the Jason Robertson deal. Shot came from Alexandrov. There's Sogard with the save, but Timor still pressing. Shot attempt from Tomasino. That was Lavoie who came back and didn't let him shoot the puck. Team Cherry, they seem to be coordinated early in this game. Good chemistry early. Cousins down to Lavoie, behind the net, tried to center it. It got right there to Nolan Foote. Cousins is there. The puck is loose. Foote reaching for it. Jones can't find it, but it was retrieved by Sasha Mutala. Now it's Team Orr's turn. Tomasino drops it back for Thompson. That shot, no problem for Sogard. Constantino pass to center ice. Jake Lee of the Seattle Thunderbirds in Sherwood Park, Alberta. It's back to center, sends it in. There's Sogard out of his net again, trying to leave it for the defenseman. Pocket was picked by Connor McMichael. And from his knees, he got a backhand shot. Sogard finally finds it. McMichael has great speed, one of the top testers yesterday, and he got a chance out of it. Team Cherry leads by two, thanks to the power play goal from Samuel Poulin. Back here in Red Deer for the Sherwin-Williams CHL-NHL Top Prospects game. The coaches are Ron McLean of Team Cherry and Kelly Rudy of Team Orr. And Kelly, let's start with you. You wanted to spot them a couple to make a dramatic comeback. Is that what's happening?
Oh, yeah, we're pretty confident, RJ. We have a good bench here. We're coming off two good shifts. I believe in the guys. They got the jump on us early, but we'll be fine.
Boy, Ron, your team seems to have a lot of chemistry early.
You know, that's been the thing, RJ, that blew me away. Robin Regier, by the way, Kelly, his son's a goaltender. He's wearing a bandana just like yours. But RD is really magic. They've been, from the minute we started running breakout practices, they had that head on a swivel, tape to tape. It's just a joy to watch. It really is.
Kelly, you were a Medicine Hat goaltender. Mad Sogard, Medicine Hat goaltender. Is it like looking in a mirror?
Well, no. I'm short and stumpy. He's tall and lean.
6'7". There he is again. Stopping Kelly Rudy's team more.
That's
chance.
That's our third good shift in a row. We like it.
Yeah, you definitely, Kelly, come on a little bit here, but that's what Sogard, you told me about him on Hockey Night in Canada.
Yes, I did. Right?
He's fantastic. And I love Taylor Gauthier, our other goalie, Kelly.
Yes.
Prince George Cougars are shortest bus trips, 6 hours. So the driver, Ralph, will say hi to you over in PG. You got to be committed when you're a Cougar, and they are so proud over there.
No kidding. They've got a great goaltender, Taylor Gauthier. We'll see him shortly. Thank you, Ron. And Kelly, we'll check in with you a little bit later. You got to get back to running those benches.
Go, 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 go.
Bowen Byram, the smooth skating defenseman, up to Peyton Krebs. He's been in the middle of things. Nick Robertson has too. Tried to pass it quickly to the front of the net. He was looking for Kaliev. Kaliev cracked down Guskov, forced him to dump the puck in. Now Arthur Kaliev skates past Guskov, drops it out for Krebs. Puck bounces into the Team Orr bench near Kelly, fortunately just far enough away. TV guys, we don't want to get hit.
No. Well, if you think about Mad Sogard, I don't know if the career is going to work out in hockey or not, but maybe he can become a pitcher, kind of like Noah Syndergaard, or maybe a movie star like Thor. He's got that same look. He's got the blonde flowing locks, good looking dude. 6'7", you got to love him.
He might be the tallest of the three.
Yeah.
I think Syndergaard's about 6'6". Well, Sogard's look good on this push from Team Orr. Here they come again, trying to get into Team Cherry's end, but Oleg Zaitsev, he's number 13. He plays here in Red Deer. He manages to score. The roof might come off the Centrium. Brett Leeson, this is what Team Orr needs. Good low shot. The rebound was there for a moment, but Peltier was tied up by Zaitsev. He couldn't get to the rebound on that terrific shot from Leeson. Kirby Dach, he's hit into the boards from Vukojevic. Slow to get up, looks to be okay though. Vukojevic has to hurry. Dach was able to lift his stick. Little help from Peltier, and they got the puck. Harley defenses it to Chankovic. Here's Vukojevic. Poulin, bothered by Kolyachunik. He'll send it back. Team Cherry getting things organized. Janison Reese. Plays with a Sarnia Sting. Darian Hatcher, David Legwan, Brad Stavitz, great school coaching staff there. Josh Williams, he's hit by Bolduc. Lee comes down to get it back to Williams. And he gets hit by Bolduc again. We're seeing a lot of physical play from Samuel Bolduc.
Yeah, he stepped up on a couple of occasions, moves the puck well. I really like his game, the Blainville Wabrian Armada.
Interesting talking to the defensemen. They all said they're two-way defensemen. Nobody said stay at home. Nobody said they're an offensive guy. They all want to be two-way guys. So we'll see what happens in this game.
That's good coaching.
they know how to answer that question. Reese behind the net. Pass back to Bolduc. Snaps a shot. That hits some traffic in front of the net. Joe Carroll has Reese on his back. All he can do is move it a few feet to Ryan Suzuki, the younger brother of Nick Suzuki, who was so good in this game, wound up being a first-round pick of the Vegas Golden Knights, then traded to Montreal. Now he's with the Guelph Storm, and they've beefed up for a playoff run this year.
Yeah, they sure have. He's reunited with his old buddy
Isaac Ratcliffe. Good opportunity through neutral ice as Team Cherry gets caught up ice, but watch Oleg Zaitsev, number 13, get back into play. Vukojevic is the lone defenseman. He keeps Leeson to the outside. That forces the low pad shot. Pelche would have been there for the rebound, except for the great play of Zaitsev, the Red Deer Rebel, coming back to take the stick away. Good defensive play there.
Phil Tomasino from Mississauga. He's been buzzing around in the Team Cherry end. Owen Byram, he's a Cranbrook, BC native. Nolan Foote chips it out to center. Korzak, his Kelowna Rockets teammate, doesn't let the puck get any further than that. Mutala hit by Foote. The centering pass from Alexandrov. That didn't find the intended target, who was Tomasino. Mutala picks up the puck at his own blue line, watched by both Foote and Cousins, two dangerous offensive players. Gnaizev off the stick of Alexandrov, and now he's trying to get to the puck, and Byram takes a hard hit, shielding the puck from Alexandrov. Alexandrov has it now. Charlottetown Islander tried to center it, but there's Byram. He's got it for Team Cherry. That was a hard-working shift for Byram, so all he wanted was the red line. He got it, and now he gets that change.
Well, it's not going to be easy. Take a couple of bumps, had to defend longer than he would have liked on that shift.
Minute to go in the first period. Connor McMichael using that speed, couldn't stick handle his way in. Vukojevic, he leads Team Cherry. Pass clears the zone, and Thomas Harley from Syracuse, New York. Robertson, he's from Michigan. McMichael, Graham Clark, they come up with a puck. Clark stick handling, waiting for a seam. He got a good shot, but a better save by Sogard. Right off the shoulder at 6'7" when he goes down to his knees. He's still tough to find an opening in that net.
Yeah, Clark, 15 goals with the Ottawa 67s, and you can see there an NHL shot, part of his arsenal.
Vukojevic over skates, recovered in time to get it away from Kirby Dach, but Dach retrieved it. Passes to Pelche and Leeson. He missed it. He was in a good spot, and that might be the first one he's missed this year. That was right there, and Team Orr could have used that late in the period. Good passing, but as Kelly said, they're starting to come on. It was a slow start for them. Much better second half to that period for Team Orr. Team Cherry leading 2-0.
The Sherwin-Williams CHL NHL Top Prospects Game on Sportsnet. Brought to you by Kia, proud partner of the CHL.
Sam, it's been such a good year for Brett Leeson, and that was a great chance late.
I don't think he expected this pass from Pelche. You see, Sogard had committed, and Pelche, with that great vision, realizing that Leeson, a right shot right there in front of the net, and the big guy had it roll just off the heel of his stick. And Pelche, excellent look there at Leeson, just laughing, saying, I've buried that probably 30 times this year.
99 out of 100, you'd have to think, he put in, but missed that one. Team Orr, they're trailing after the first period here in Red Deer, 2-0. It was a great start for Team Cherry, just 56 seconds in. Arthur Kaliev does what he does best. He scores. It was a great setup by Nick Robertson, and he's with Rob.
Nick, you get the setup on that first goal. Is there any comfort at all knowing that you've seen Kaliev play in your own league? Did that help at all?
Yeah, I mean, I told Artie that you know, we've been together four times, you know, on the same line in different events, like tryouts for Hlinka, American Prospects Game and this Prospects Game. So I know that side's kind of his bread and butter, and you just got to find him there, and, you know, luckily he buried it.
A lot of energy for Team Cherry in that first period. Nice to get that first goal and really take the jump, isn't it?
Yeah, I mean, for sure. I mean, I thought we got the goal on them, especially the first goal got us going, and, you know, fully got that second one. So we just keep rolling and, you know, get 2 points here.
Thanks very much.
Yeah, thank you.
Nick Robertson of the Peterborough Petes, and he gets the assist on the first goal. Right now, Team Cherry with a 2-0 lead here at the Sherwin-Williams CHL NHL Top Prospects Game. Carolyn?
Rob, that's right. An exciting first period, and shots 13-8 in favor of Team Cherry. Team Orr coming on strong in the later stages of that period. Coming up, Todd and Colby and Flames GM Brad Treliving stops by.
Your work never really stops. The jobs may change with the seasons, but the need for power, performance, and affordability doesn't. Right now,
it's the perfect time to get a great price on durable, quality Kubota equipment. Upgrade your landscaping, construction, or farming equipment and attachments, and get what you need for the months ahead. Because work never stops, and neither does Kubota. See your local Kubota dealer today.
2-0 Team Cherry after one, and Nicholas Robertson all smiles in the locker room because he has two assists on Arthur Kaliev and Samuel Foulin's goals. That's Sherwin-Williams CHL NHL Top Prospects Game. Hi again, everybody. Colby Armstrong, Todd Warner, and Carolyn Cameron with you. And you can kind of see the scouts over my shoulder all sitting in one section. If you were them, there was one line that you had your eyes on.
Yeah, for sure. And if you want to see, you know, come and watch these guys dazzle and showcase, you got it. From Nick Robertson, Peyton Krebs, who we talked off the pregame, and, you know, we touched on, obviously, Kaliev's shooting and scoring ability. And, you know, they were jumping on pucks. We see this whole shift. One guy on a guy, another guy. Krebs is right there on a guy. And then you want to get dazzled. Here we have a nice little spinorama, no look passed. But guess what? It's not really no look. We heard Nicholas Robertson talk at the end of the period, his familiarity of playing with Kaliev and their experience together on the American teams, the Hlinka. And you can sense that in that line. They were all over the ice. They were supporting each other and playing quick hockey and a fast-paced game. But the skill on that goal, the attack, the speed, the skill, man, I think everyone liked what they saw right there.
Yeah, and they had a great start to the game. And then it was great to see Brent Sutter go back to them when they got their first power play opportunity. And here's a play I want fans to see, because 10 years ago, with all these new faces and players from all over the CHL, you'd never see this a play. It's a bumper play in the middle. Watch Zaitsev, the Red Deer Rebel here, the top of the box. He's going to get a pass right there just to get him out of trouble and get the power play set up. And that's a play you usually have to run through practice, through repetition, to get some familiarity with one another. He just knows to be there. He gets Vukovic out of trouble. He gets the pass back. And then Poulin provides a great screen in front. So that's something you wouldn't have seen a few years ago, Colby, because the players are all new to each other and they had very little time to practice. But now it's just commonplace across the CHL.
So a period in, as you even saw from Team Orr near the end of that first period, I think the nerves now are finally finally wearing off. Matt Sogard, too, the giant in net. He has eight saves thus far, and everyone seems to be enjoying themselves inside the room. Coming up on set, though, we're joined by Calgary Flames GM Brad Treliving. That's next. Well, we're pleased to be joined on set by Brad Treliving, the GM of the Calgary Flames. You're headed into the All-Star break. Top team in the West, second team in the league. That's got to be a pretty good feeling this time of year.
Yeah, it has been. Obviously, the guys have done a real good job. It feels like we're going to be on break here for the next 3 months. So they're all probably saddled up to some beach bar right now. But no, the guys have done a good job. The coaching staff, players have done an excellent job. Having said that, we know there's lots of work ahead. So, you know, we'll get this break, hopefully refresh a little bit and get ready for the 30 games that are left.
So we have a stat that 19 of your last 30 draft picks have been from the CHL. So we're proud to say that. Who is coming that we may know of in the pipeline to help the Flames in the immediate future?
Yeah, well, the CHL has been real good to us. You know, a couple guys in particular through the CHL, Dylan Dubé, who was our second-round pick for us a couple years ago, was in Kelowna. Actually made our team at a training camp, and you know, a real good young player. He's down in Stockton with the with our American League team right now. Yusuf Valimaki, out of Tri-Cities, suffered a high ankle sprain, and hopefully is on the mend now. Is doing some rehab down in Stockton, and you know, one of the I think he was the MVP of the league last year in Swift Current, Glenn Godden. So you know, throughout both the Western League, Ontario and Quebec, they've been real good to the Flames.
Okay, so we've seen your team, obviously, first in the West. Five players on your team, league-leading over 50 points, 55-plus points. Heading into the trade deadline, 4 or 5 weeks away, what are you looking at right now with your Flames team? Doing so well, adding anything, staying put, looking at everything?
Yeah, all of the above. I mean, we just finished our meeting, so now is the time where there's lots of dialogue between managers and whatnot. And twofold, you always want to help your team if you can. You're trying to balance that with not trying to mess with the chemistry in the mix. So, you know, we're looking both at forward and defense if there's ways to help us. And You know, everything comes into play when you talk about the prices and what all those things cost. So we got a month here of really continuing to watch our team, and hopefully, you know, health always plays a big part of it, and we can stay healthy and see where we get to before the deadline.
We'll just keep feeding Goudreau whatever you've been feeding.
Yeah, yeah.
That ham sandwiches or whatever.
Gatorade
purple
or whatever
Gatorade, the there you drinking. Go. Or.
And Matthew Tkachuk, I think a lot of fans here probably remember watching him at the Memorial Cup and you watching him in the top prospects. A lot of Flames jerseys around here as well. So thanks very much for joining us.
You bet. Sure. Thanks for having me.
Good feedback from everyone in this building.
Thank you.
So it's 2-0 for Team Cherry and a good year thus far for the Calgary Flames. Two nothing, Team Cherry at the Centrium after one, but here is Rob Falds with Team Orr captain Kirby Dach.
From the Saskatoon Blades, Kirby, you're looking up at the big screen, seeing some of the opportunities. Did it take a while for Team Orr to feel comfortable?
Yeah, I think we came out a little bit nervous in the first 10 minutes, and then after that 10-minute TV timeout, we kind of found our legs and got going, and we just got to bear down on our chances.
Yeah, and you had some great chances in that one. So is it a matter of just simply attacking the net now and really sticking to the game plan that you want to put in place?
Yeah, I think so. I think we need to get pucks in deep and get our forecheck going, because when we got our legs moving, we're a pretty tough team to handle down low. And if we funnel puck towards the net, I think we'll be okay.
Thanks very much.
All right, thank you.
Kirby Dach is the captain of Team Orr, and they are ready to go for period number two. Trying to get a couple of goals right now. It is Team Cherry leading 2-0. Ready with the call for the second period. Here's RJ Broadhead, Sam Cosentino.
What a great start it was for Team Cherry in the game, Rob. 56 seconds in, Arthur Kaliev scored, and Brent Sutter, Dave Hunter, Ron McLean, you know what they're doing. They've got that same trio out to start this period. Maybe get off to another good start in the second. Krebs pass. That's intercepted by Williams. Put it to the front of the net. Ryan Suzuki. He leads the Barry Colts in scoring. There's a shot in on Sogard. He's been rock solid for Team Cherry, as he has for the Medicine Hat Tigers this season. Nick Robertson deking his way to the outside. Got around a couple of Team Orr players. Made a pass, but it went off a stick and out of play.
Well, Robertson, we saw his brother Jason play so well in the Ontario Hockey League and continues to do so with the Niagara Ice Dogs. Jason, the second round pick of the Dallas Stars, and Nick really trying to follow his footsteps. Said he took a lot from his brother, going through the experience, being seen by scouts, being interviewed all the time, trying to concentrate on your studies, trying to concentrate on what's happening on the ice. He's done a good job for Peterborough in that regard.
Huck Shannon and the speedy Team Orr duo. Connor McMichael. And in front of the goal, that's Graham Clark. Team Orr trying to get a shot through at the blue line. Ohachik to Clark. The Ottawa 67's hookup. Guskov tries his shot. Nothing doing. Mads Sogard is guarded his net well. Steal by Team Orr. Puck came in front of the net, but Matthew Robertson was there to take it away from the front of the goal. This will go all the way on net. Hunter Jones forced to cover it up with Samuel Poulin right there.
Mads Sogard has looked really sharp in goal for Team Cherry. Wasn't tested that often in the first portion of the first period, but right away, Team Orr comes out, gets a good shot on him, gets down in that butterfly, makes a good stop, and then Guskov chases down the rebound. Guskov of the London Knights, but Sogard with a good push off that left skate gets across to keep it out of the net.
Shots might be a little stingy. Only one shot for Team Orr in the period. Feels like they've tested Sogard a little more than that. Mutala can't get a pass past Owen Byron. Constantino knocks Mukala down. Nussbaumer is stopped by Alexandrov. Nikita Alexandrov looks to the blue line. Open there is Lassie Thompson. The shot is blocked, and it's cleared by Nathan Legare right into the Team Orr bench.
Alexandrov of the Charlottetown Islanders playing for Jim Halton there. An interesting story in that he has both a German and a Russian passport. And talking to Jim Halton the other day about Alexandrov, a guy that he really likes, a highly skilled guy, continues to work on his play away from the puck and on his D-zone game.
Constantino quickly after that puck, he's cut off by Mutala. Tomasino digs it loose, tried to center it, but Alexandrov had his stick lifted by Byron. This is sent down the ice. It's wide of the net, and Team Cherry has iced it. The 2019 Honda NHL All-Star Weekend kicks off with the skills competition. Watch your favorite stars take part in the fastest skater, accuracy, shooting, and many more events. Coverage begins Friday at 9 p.m. on Sportsnet and CBC. This is not an All-Star game because these players are trying to help their draft position. Most of them are 17. There's a few late birthdays or early birthdays here in January for a few players who have turned 18. And then there's Brett Leeson, who's 19. Cutting to the net was Alexandrov. He's had a few chances on that shift, but nothing doing with big Mad Sogard. He stopped every chance Team Orr had.
Well, Alexandrov with a good chance there. Was a guy who started last year and was a little bit homesick, and then after Christmas, the break seemed to play much better. Really a breakout in the playoffs, 70 points in 18 games. And being born on September 16th, 2000, the oldest guy of the first-year draft eligible.
Right off the faceoff, Leeson walked in front and he narrowly missed. Thompson takes a shot that's blocked by Nolan Foote, and Raphael Lavoie battles his way through center. Lee doesn't let Team Cherry get into the zone. Kirby Dach, he's on a line with Brent Leeson. Prince Albert and Saskatoon are the two top teams in the Eastern Conference, so right now, Dach and Leeson, they can be pals, but that's going to change over the next few months when those two teams and the playoffs set up in the Western Hockey League. That could be a fairly early matchup, maybe second round.
I'll have to try and find a way to get along here for the next hour and a half.
They'll do it. Long shot in on Hunter Jones, and he just redirects that out of play.
Brett Leeson with a couple of golden opportunities in this game towards the end of period number one. Pelche set him up and had the puck slip underneath the blade, but here off the draw, he swoops in off the wind from Dach, and with that good shooting ability, just misses the net. But you have to like it if you're a scout. You're looking down, you're saying, well, this guy's had good chances. He's been in good position. He just hasn't had the luck to find the back of the net yet.
And you know he can finish with the numbers he's put up, 73 points. That's fourth in the Western Hockey League, most of any player here in Red Deer. Robertson tried to settle down the bouncing puck, couldn't do it. Now he's got to get back. Nick Robertson, very aware. He covered up for the defenseman and made a good defensive play on Ryan Suzuki. Knocked the puck loose, allowed Robertson to get back into position, as in Matthew Robertson. No relation, the two Robertsons, but they are good buddies. Peyton Krebs loses it to Joe Carroll, center to Williams, and he missed the net. Looks like Team Orr, with the size of Mads Sogard, they're just trying to be perfect with their shots, and they're missing.
Good opportunity, though. The forecheck, quick pass, good puck movement.
Robertson sent it back to the blue line. The defensemen were on a change. Fresh defenseman out there. It's Constantino and Byron. Puck kept in by Bowen Byron. Rolls it down to the corner. Kaliev, he chops at it. Team Orr steals it away. Graham Clark, quick give and go with Suzuki. Clark centers it, and Guskov couldn't reach that puck. Clark, he's got it again. Right in the middle of the ice, he deked around everybody and scored. What a tremendous goal! Graham Clark!
Well, Kelly Rudy said the first period he felt like they were building some momentum as the period moved on, and they took that momentum and come out flying here. Has Team Orr in this second period, and Graham Clark with those 15 goals for the Ottawa 67s does a great job deking through the middle of the ice, leaves the puck one move to the inside, back to the outside with that great shooting ability. He's able to pull big Sogard out of position and slip it underneath him to get Team Orr on the board. Even Sogard with that long reach couldn't get over there with that left pat.
Graham Clark has battled injuries, and he's rounding into form. That's a pretty good sign right there. What a wonderful goal by Graham Clark. He's from Ottawa, plays with the 67s, and there's a good example of why Ottawa is the top team in the Ontario Hockey League right now.
He grew up watching guys like Toffoli and Monahan, and now trying to be one of those guys.
Trajkovic, centering attempt, missed everybody, so Sogard comes out. Leads it for Michael Vukojevic. He has an assist in this game on the power play goal scored by Samuel Poulin. Max Trajkovic had to dance around a check from Alexandra. Vukojevic again up the middle. That didn't work. Kolyachanuk got a stick on Poulin. closes in on a Hutcher. Another Ottawa 67. Knock him down. Ocala with a speedy Phil Tomasino. Reinforcements. Couldn't get it through to them. And Chaykovic leads the Sea Dogs in scoring, looking to get it to the net. He got it down there, and the rebound right on Hunter Jones. No one around for Team Cherry, so he's got to keep that in play. That was a sneaky second shot.
Really good awareness by Jones, though. He didn't give up on the play. He saw he had numbers back there.
Tomasino to the front of the net. That's broken up by Bolduc. And Jamison Reese, it's his turn now. On the backhand, spins in the corner. That'll come outside the zone. Robertson has to be careful. He knew Kirby Dach was right on his heels. Robertson sends it in. That's off to the bench for him. Hunter Jones moves it to the corner, but Nathan Légaré, first one to it. Nine-game point streak for Légaré with a Baie-Comeau Dracar. They're back to prominence in the Quebec Major Junior Hockey League, too.
Oh, yeah, Marty Bernard and his team have won 10 straight. They're doing a great job over there in Baie-Comeau.
Lassie Thompson under duress, stolen by Raphael Lavoie. Right in front of the net to Reese, and he just missed Nussbaum. Lifted to the front of the goal. Thompson knocks it down. Lavoie gave him a couple of whacks as he skates away. The smooth skating defenseman took a wrist shot, but it missed the net. Another smooth skating defenseman. It's Byram. Joined by Lavoie. Byram goes to the front of the net. Lavoie couldn't get him the puck. Halifax Mooseheads. They've had some great players play in this game recently. Nathan MacKinnon, Jonathan Drouin, Nico Hischier. Not too long ago, just a couple of years ago, first overall pick.
Turn back the clock a little bit. Nick Ehlers, Timo Meyer.
Some good ones from Halifax. Lavoie. He's in that mix, and of course, Halifax hosting the Memorial Cup this year. They're excellent in the Quebec Major Junior Hockey League, too.
Eric Villa, former champion with Shawinigan back in 2012, their head coach there.
Byram slides it ahead for Dylan Cousins, Whitehorse, Yukon. It's a short list of players from the Yukon who have played in the NHL. Dylan Cousins, he could have streets named after him the way he's going on the course he's on. There's Brett Leeson. He walked around, one hit, got a hard wrist shot on goal, and Mads Sogard had everything covered on that glove side. Graham Clark, one of the best goals you'll see to get Timor on the board.
Helping out Mark Abshott on Timor is Robin Regeer, and I don't mean to date you, but what do you remember of playing in Top Prospects in 1998?
Well, Don Cherry and Bobby Orr doing their thing, and I remember how nervous I was at the start of the game, and I think that happened to us tonight. You know, the kids are a little bit nervous, but we found our game now, and we're coming on strong.
These kids want to be where you were in the National Hockey League. Earlier today, you showed them a special prize that you've got. You showed them your Stanley Cup ring. We've got some great video of the wide eyes on these kids when they realize not only is the NHL a goal, that's the ultimate goal.
Yeah, for sure. You know, for me, it was special to be able to share it with them and be a part of this event and try to help them relax. But I also wanted to show them that, you know, this is one small step along the way to getting to the National Hockey League and hopefully getting to win a championship.
Robin, great to see you. Kelly, RJ mentioned it. You said they thought your team was getting a little more momentum. You're starting to see that now.
Definitely. I thought the last 8 minutes of that first period, we gained some momentum, picked up our tempo. We talked about it in the dressing room, and we've carried it over here in the second.
Guys, Kelly called the referee over and said, what's it like to go through a game when nobody's yelling at you?
Well, it's still early.
Well, that's true. They can hopefully have a quiet night. Shot came from Joe Carroll, stopped by Mads Sogard, and backed that up for Team Orr. They had 8 shots in all of the first period. We're not even halfway through the second, and they've got 7. Maybe they'll get their 8. They do! Down there on Sogard, traffic in front, a tipped shot, but he stops it again.
Well, this line's been particularly effective here in the second period. You have Ryan Suzuki, the Barry Colts. You have Josh Williams and the Edmonton Oil Kings. And Joe Carroll, the Sault Ste. Marie Greyhounds, who's really had a resurgence since coming back from the Christmas break playing for John Dean and the red hot Sault Ste. Marie Greyhounds.
Here comes Team Cherry. Nick Robertson lost it at the line, quickly cleared, but Vukojevic has it back. Hunter Jones These two goaltenders know their work's almost done. It will be a split between the two goaltenders on each team. Both have played excellent. Early goal from Kaliev. He was set up perfectly. One-timer, one of the best scorers in all of the CHL. And then a power play goal. That's all that got past Hunter Jones. Chaikovich. Nice shot. That's stopped by Jones.
The Sherwin-Williams CHL NHL Top Prospects Game on Sportsnet. Brought to you by CIBC, the official bank of the Canadian Hockey League. CIBC, banking that fits your life.
Face off, won by Timor. They control behind their net, but Zaitsev a steal. Here's Chaikovich. Centered it, couldn't connect with Poulin. Moore, they've scored in this period. Graham Clark, a beauty. Jones still busy in the Timor net. Made the saves. Now it's time for the offense to go to work, and Graham Clark's out there again. McMichael to Guskov. Missed the net. Clark gets it again. Rolls it down for Connor McMichael. Off the side of the net. That'll work out okay. Jake Lee at the blue line. Wrist shot. That deflects one. Zaitsev speeds away from Guskov. Two Russian players. Connor McMichael lifts that high in the air. Robertson, as in Matthew, was the first to detect where it was, and it turned into an easy clear for him. McMichael's been out there for a while, so Robertson steals the puck. Bolduc up ahead for Chaikovich. Seems like a long shift for him, too. Not much left, and open ice for Graham Clark. We've seen what he can do. Clark gets it again, passes back to Guskov. Team Cherry right back the other way. Korzak stops Team Cherry, and here comes Team Orr. Guskov takes the shot. Sogard the save. He didn't let a rebound up. And that should be it for the two goaltenders. Rock solid work from Mad Sogard and Hunter Jones. We'll talk about the new goalies when we come back. New goalies here in Red Deer for Team Cherry. It's Taylor Gauthier. He's from Calgary, plays with the Prince George Cougars. First Prince George goalie with three shutouts in a season since Ty Edmonds 3 years ago, and he catches with his right hand. It was pretty interesting to see the players over the last 2 days, how many times he made those great glove saves. Colton Ellis, he's from Wicokama, Nova Scotia, the only Maritimer in this event. Plays with the Rimouski Oceanic. He's currently on a personal four-game winning streak. That's his best of the season with Rimouski, and there's Hunter Jones and Mads Sogard. They were really good.
Yeah, they each give each other a little hand tap on the way out. A little bit of sportsmanship being shown by the two goalies now out of the game.
Shot from Korzak. For Jones, he allowed two goals on 20 shots. For Sogard, just the one goal on 18 shots. Always tough to come in mid-game, but at least these two goalies knew that was the scenario. They knew they were coming in, so they could prepare for it. Legare back to Byron, looking for a lane to shoot. Alexandrov stayed right in that lane, so he was forced to send it down low. Nussbaumer, Legare, Reese comes over to help Team Cherry keep the offense going. Constantino trying to move, and Tomasino almost stole it. Constantino gets it back. Legare centered it. Nussbaumer couldn't get a stick on it. Byron's in there. He's got the puck. The defenseman trying to spin away from trouble. Decided to center it, and Korzak plays it off the glass down the ice, and Timor has iced it.
We talked a little bit about Gauthier and the three shutouts for Prince George, but Colton Ellis, quite the shutout magician of his own. You go back to last year, the 2017-18 season, set a QMJHL rookie record for goaltenders with six shutouts, and interesting in that he was drafted by Cape Breton, moved to Rimouski, and got all kinds of opportunity, more than he thought last year, to help earn him that record.
This is a haggard group out there for Timor. Mark Abshide, Kelly Rudy, Robin Regeer. They want to see them get a whistle, maybe get the puck out. It's a long change in the second period. Looks good here, out of the reach of Tomasino. It'll roll down to Gauthier, and that's his first touch. Always nice to at least touch the puck. That's pretty much all that was. Lavoie got the hair flowing here for the Team Cherry. Halifax Moosehead star, hard pass, and it was knocked out of play into the crowd.
Dylan Cousins, the captain, giving way here to Raphael Lavoie of the Halifax Mooseheads. We've talked about just how highly successful an organization that has been. And Lavoie's a really interesting character in that it looks like he's playing the game in a rocking chair. The next thing you know, he's hacking and whacking a stick. He's getting a good shot on goal. An excellent shooter who skates well for a big man.
Top-ranked player from the QMJHL. Here's Nikita Hotchuk. Not a lot of offense, but he tells me that his coach in Ottawa, Andre Tournier, said he can have the green light if he wants it. Feels he's better off staying defensive, throwing a couple of big hits. Picks his spots, though. Had a couple of injuries. Hotchuk, good pass. Right on the tape of the captain, Kirby Dach. Top-ranked player. Number two among North American skaters. According to Central Scouting, according to Sam Cosentino's rankings on Sportsnet.ca, pretty interested. You've got Dylan Cousins just ahead of Dach.
Slightly ahead.
Pass in front of the net. Gauthier almost passed it there. That'll be one of the battles to watch right through to June.
We're talking about Jack Hughes of the U.S. program as being the guy to go first overall. Kaapo Kakko of Finland projected to go second, and then looks like that's the Cousins Dach race begins shortly thereafter. But really, you're talking about two big right shot centermen. What's not to like about that? You know, Dach's the bigger, heavier guy. Cousins has room to put on weight. Todd and Colby talking about each of those players off the top of the broadcast, but very bright futures ahead for both.
One thing that was sort of interesting with the testing is for Dylan Cousins, there's a grip strength test.
Yeah.
And he finished first in both the right-hand grip and the left-hand grip.
Yeah, so much for the strong hand. You usually have one.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Pass into the middle of the ice. That's intercepted by Joe Carroll. Plays with the Sault Ste. Marie Greyhounds, a 10th straight year that the Greyhounds have been represented at this event, and that's a record. They always seem to have great teams and just enough youth coming up to keep that rolling. Kyle Raftus, the general manager, has done a great job making sure the young players are still there. Hard shot from Bull Duke, but nothing that Colton Ellis hasn't seen before in the QMJHL. He makes the save.
And things starting to even out a little more. It was Team Orr with that big push early in the period. The Team Cherry now starting to go to work here a little bit on the forecheck. Turnover created, swung back to the point, but no traffic there. And Colton Ellis of the Rimouski Oceanic, who made the QMJHL All Rookie Team last year, went 33-14.
Great start to his QMJHL career. Maxim Chankovic. Drops it off for Oleg Zaitsev. Couldn't get a opening to get to the net. Graham Clark trying to stop Zaitsev. He did. And now Connor McMichael. Stick handles in that sea of red sweaters. Ruskov misses Clark with his pass. And here's Bowen Byram. He's been jumping up into the play. One of the leading scorers among WHL defensemen. Constantino. Rolls it behind the net. Chaikovich, Samuel Poulin. He wears number 92, but with Sherbrooke, he wears number 29. Long shot in on Colton Ellis. Pretty interesting. Legare, Poulin, and Nolan Foote all wear number 29 with their respective teams. Only Foote got it. We'll take a break. 2-1 here for Team Cherry.
On the Road is brought to you by Cooper Tires. You can count on Cooper since 1914. Medicine Hat Tiger, take a look at this picture. That is Kelly Rudy. He was a member of the Tigers from 78 to 81, drafted by the Islanders in 1980 in the second round, number 38. Played for the Islanders for six seasons, then on to the LA Kings and finished up in San Jose, 677 games. Another goaltender who plays with Medicine Hat has done his night's work, and Matt Sogard, did you enjoy the experience?
Oh, yeah, it was a lot of fun and great experience. Just overall, I liked it so far.
How difficult is it to play in a game like this where you don't know many of the shooters?
You know, obviously it's difficult with the shooters, but I think our team did a great job and helped me out a lot, so thanks for that.
Now the rest of the game, you're a cheerleader?
Yeah, I'm just cheering the voice on out here.
Enjoy.
Thanks.
Love it.
Rob Smart I believe the 6'7" guy without skates yeah. who's now on skates sitting down when you interview him.
Yeah, veteran move.
Saves the shoulder. Both the new goalies, Ellis and Gauthier, have each faced a pair of shots. No damage done. Puck flipped in the air. Thomas Harley, smooth strides. He gets there first. Puck got to the top of the slot. Legare chips it for Jameson Reese. Trying to get around a hot shoot. He got a shot. Colton Ellis, calm save in there for Timor. Another long shot. Blockered past Reese. Ellis may have sensed he was there and really drove that rebound to the corner off the blocker. Ohachuk at the, or Kolejachonik rather, at the blue line, lifted that over the glass.
Well, Thomas Harley, when the latest rankings came out on Monday, Thomas Harley was the highest ranked OHL player, checking in at number 9. The Mississauga Steelheads have had a pretty good recent history of high draft picks, going back to Owen Tippett and the McLeod brothers, Nick Hague, and Harley looks to be the next in that nice long list.
Samuel Bolduc almost fell down. That's trouble. Dach steals it. Cut in front. Gauthier had to make a good save on the dangerous Dach. Bavois chips it past Lee. No problem. Lassie Thompson's there. Cousins right on him, but Thompson wasted no time. He skated away from that trouble. Bolduc spins away. He ran into his own man, and now Gauthier comes out, plays the puck. How about that left wing side for Team Cherry? That worked better. Nolan Foote, quick pass to Cousins. Here's LeBlanc. Stops and lets that wave of players go by. Got the shot on Ellis. He hasn't allowed many rebounds. There was one that time, but Timor got to it. Here's Jacob Telchik. Had a great season with the Moncton Wildcats. Kirby Dach is behind the Team Cherry net. Josh Williams comes in to help out. Bolduc drives the puck away from him. Dach is hit by Robertson. Graham, rather that was Joe Carroll trying to stick handle out of the corner. There is a penalty coming up, and there will be a power play. Might see some power plays tomorrow, too. Brett Leeson and the number one team in the CHL, the Prince Albert Raiders, take on Bowen Byram and the Vancouver Giants. It's the CHL on Sportsnet tomorrow at 10:30 Eastern time on Sportsnet.
Oh, man, am I looking forward to that. Game still lots to play here, though. Joe Carroll gives up the puck, and as he did so, it got away from him, committed the interference infraction. We'll head to the box for Team Orr and see if Team Cherry can grab some momentum back.
Team Cherry had a 2-0 lead. They still lead by one. They're 1-for-1 on the power play. Here's Kaliev. He passes deep to Robertson. Oh, what a pass that was. Perfect. Peyton Krebs. Another power play goal. And Team Cherry's up 3-1.
Well, that didn't take long. Just 21 seconds into the power play. Peyton Krebs with great recognition. You have to love how these players have their awareness about them, even though they don't get to play with one another in the regular season. But Robertson does such a great job here. Right side of your screen, sneaking out of nowhere, you'll see Peyton Krebs. As Robertson gets it back at the goal line, he waits, opens up a seam with a little deke, and that allows Krebs time to get down into perfect scoring position, a wide open net as Robertson threads the needle. Beautiful, beautiful look there.
Kind of get the feeling that Nick Robertson's helping his stock
in
this game.
Yeah, he has played extremely well.
Two great passes. Setting up goals for Team Cherry. Two power play goals. So this is something these players haven't had a chance to work on. Just go out and use your skills. And Team Cherry's been good, 2-for-2. Just under 2.5 minutes to go in period 2. Williams checked by Byron. Wants to get the puck back, but Byron's so elusive back there. Spun away. Now he's jumped into the play, and he leads Team Cherry into the Timor zone. Byram into the middle of the ice, and Ellis, top of his crease, makes the save.
You know, unbelievable awareness on these two players, and that's why they like on the power play to have that player on the goal line, because he has the entire play in front of him, the rest of his teammates in front of him. But Peyton Krebs, so brilliant here. Robertson does such a great job just extending, opening up the hole. He sees Krebs the entire time sneaking down on that left wing side, and he's got a wide open net.
Time to play catch up again, down by two, Timor. Might be something here. Connor McMichael, 27 goals to the London Knights, passes to Lee. And he rolled it down to the goal, and Gauthier didn't allow Timor anything else.
Yeah, Gauthier could have opened up there the five hole, but did a good job getting in that butterfly, sliding across, took that puck right in the middle off of the deflection. Looked to be a little bit more dangerous. McMichael getting it back and slid down, but hit a skate first.
Tchaikovich, checked by Lee. Now next up is Poulin. He knocked it off his stick, but it went right to Tchaikovich. Thompson. Over to McMichael. Graham Clark back to McMichael. Gustav has a lane on the left wing side. Pass went off the skate of Vukojevic, and Gauthier made a wonderful save. Made that look easier than it was.
He sure did, and it was the exact same thing that happened to save previously. A pass that looked to be extending past the crease actually hits the skate of his own defenseman, Vukojevic. But Taylor Gauthier does such a great job here with this athleticism. He doesn't open up, and he closes, keeps that door closed, not allowing the puck to go through off the skate deflection.
Time winding down, second period. Timor, they're desperate to get to at least one of Team Cherry before this period's done. Looks good here. Artemi Knyazev looking for that deflection in front of the net. Someone got a piece of it, but just knocked it wide. Rotella behind the net. Tomasino's wide open. Tried to get to the front, and it was poked away. Might have been poked away by Gauthier himself, the goaltender. Alexandra battling against Reese. There's going to be a penalty. That might be going against Reese. And Tomasino, he's spinning around. Look at this hard work by Timor. They were relentless. Didn't get that late shot, but they did draw a penalty.
And that's what happens when you play in the offensive zone. You're playing on the right side. At some point, the defenders are going to get tired. And it's Jameson Reese of the Sarnia Sting who gets called for the holding infraction. He loses his check here and drags the shirt of Alexandrov down. And as he does so, pulls him off stride just enough to earn himself the penalty.
50 seconds to go in the period, so this will be less than a minute for Timor to get something going here in the second on this power play. And eyes out. Over to Dach. Low shot, wide of the net. That'll be retrieved by Thompson. Over to Dach. Cousins forces him to spin back. Thompson at the blue line, right back to Dach. Gets a little closer to the net, passes, and that was under the stick of Pelche. He had it lifted. It'll come outside the Team Cherry zone. That forces Timor to regroup. Pelche brings it right back in. Still time here for Timor. Dach with Cousins all over him. Byram comes over to help out. They can't get it away from Dach. Leeson now trying to get to the net. Constantino knocked it off his stick. Only 5 seconds to go in the period. They're going to have to shoot. And they tried that late shot, but it was a glove pass.
A good attempt here to try and get something done. Brett Leeson with that big smile. 5 shots on goal now for Team Orr. Having a smile with Bowen Byram. That won't be the case tomorrow night when the two meet in Vancouver at the Langley Event Center. Brett Leeson and the number one ranked Prince Albert Raiders up against Bowen Byram and the Vancouver Giants.
Giants having a great year, too. That's it for the second period, so there will be just over a minute of power play time that carries over for Team Orr. Pretty entertaining stuff. Another power play goal for Team Cherry. Pretty interesting there, too, that they have such chemistry on that power play. What a goal we saw in that period from Graham Clark. It was like the puck was stuck to his stick. He was in traffic. He stick handled around and put it in the net. It's one of those goals that he'll probably remember forever and probably will get shown a lot when this event rolls around every year. Just a tremendous goal from Graham Clark with the number one team in the OHL, the Ottawa 67s, and Graham is with Rob.
Graham, RJ Broadhead, Sam Cosentino talking about your goal that you were really doing a little magic there with the stick. How comfortable are you in a game like this?
Yeah, I think the big thing for me is I just want to have fun out here. You know, that's what it's about. Obviously, show your skills off, and to win, obviously, we're trying to get back in this game. But it's a lot of fun to be out here for sure.
Did you find that early in that first period it took you guys a little bit of time to mesh, but you can feel that momentum and that comfort with one another?
For sure. Once you start to touch the puck a little bit and make plays with your line mates, everything becomes more comfortable. And I think that's what our team has done here. We've picked it up definitely in the second half and ready to go.
You know, you've had some opportunities. So now in the third period, it's a matter of just driving.
Exactly. It's a matter of execution, getting it done, and ultimately putting the puck in the net. So, yeah.
Thanks very much.
Thank you.
Graham Clark, he gets the goal for Team Orr, but they trail by two after 40 minutes here in Red Deer. Carolyn?
Well, Graham said to us this week that he looks up to Stamkos, Pasternak, and Besser. Not many players gave us more than one player, but maybe that's where he gets those hands. It's 3-1 Cherry. Todd and Colby's thoughts next. The top prospects of the future, perhaps, seeing the future stars of the NHL. It's Team Cherry up 3-1, Graham Clark and Peyton Krebs with the goals as that Krebs line for Team Cherry continues to do well. Now it's time for the Kia CHL Top 10. Kia is a proud partner of the CHL. And we want to speak about Raphaël Lavoie. We welcome back Colby Armstrong and Todd Warner from the Halifax Mooseheads. He's fifth on this list. And he and his Mooseheads, of course, will be hosting the Memorial Cup presented by Kia come May. And Colby, you've liked what you've seen from Lavoie tonight.
Yeah, so he's a guaranteed guy we're going to see at the Memorial Cup, which I like as well. Yeah, and I've liked him. He's jumped out at me. He's a big body guy at 6'4", about 195. And you look at his skill set. We heard Sam and RJ also talk, a centerman, can play wing, right-handed shot. But the way he uses his body, the way he uses his legs, you know, to power through guys, and you know, this is important when you have that big down low game. And then we saw his ability with speed through the neutral zone to attack defenders, get pucks wide to the outside, and hang on to pucks and create chances. Here he is at the end of a long shift, but he said, I'm big, I'm strong, I can still make a shot at it, and comes in for a nice effort. But he's a guy in Halifax we will see at the Memorial Cup, a guy that's big, a guy has that nice frame on him, NHL yep. style, a guy's, you know, scouts will really like you. Notice it jumps out, but he uses it really well. He uses it like a pro, and a guy for me that's standing out and doing that. All those little things, 200-foot game, offensive ability, big body game.
We'll see him in Halifax, and I think all of his hometown, Chambly, Quebec, is probably watching tonight because his dad is the longtime mayor. His dad doesn't like
the mayor,
hockey.
The mayor,
but
right.
Raphael said, he said he doesn't like hockey, but he likes me, so he'll be watching. Everybody was watching Graham Clark's goal. Oh, the hands on that goal. We've kind of seen that creativity before.
And we have. He's been known for these highlight reel kind of goals, lacrosse-style goals back in Ottawa where he plays, and putting in a Cy Young kind of season. But this is a nice play by Suzuki just to spin away. Watch the 10-2 there to get the defenseman to bite. Stays with it. Now he's going to not handle it, folks. Not handle it. And it goes under the triangle. And then he makes a nice play to finish that off. So great play by Graham Clark. A lot of chances by Orr here. Bottom right here. Suzuki watches on the stick, off the stick, right under Williams. Puts it on the net. Leeson with a number of good chances. Here's Guskov with McMichael, the London combination, heating up in this period as well. And that allowed Orr, I thought, to push the momentum of this period until the late power play goal. But good job. Lots of good opportunities by these pairings they put together with some sync.
Well, and we'll see what some of the scouts and GMs are thinking, because Dale Talon, the GM of the Florida Panthers, he's going to be joining us next. Graham Clark, he puts Team Orr on the board, but they're down 3-1 after two. Lots of skill on the ice. You won't see any fighting, though. So, guys, come on, keep it down. It's 3-1 Team Cherry after one. It's all in good fun. Everything's fine. And we're pleased to welcome in the GM of the Florida Panthers, Dave Talon. And if I think back of probably your favorite prospects games, I think back to when you were with Chicago and Patrick Kane watching him. What do you make of these youngsters tonight?
Well, they're really playing hard. Most of the time, it's like an all-star type game and not a lot of hitting or competing, but these kids have worked extremely hard, a lot of a good competition. That's what I like to see. You know, some great plays, some good saves. It's been a good first 40 minutes, I think.
So we talk about CHL, top prospects game. I look at what you guys have done. Sarah Noel, player that we love. We love watching him.
Nice player.
Owen Tippett, drafted by you guys high. Yeah. Alexi Heponiemi, great Finnish player. That was when Swift Current Memorial Cup. Loved him.
Right.
What is it about these CHL players that you love drafting?
Well, the best
so
young players in the world come out of these leagues, the Canadian Hockey League. I mean, the competition, the coaching, you know, the whole thing. It's just the passion that they have. And obviously, it's easier to get to those teams than going to Finland or Russia or whatever. But, you know, it's become a global game, but still the CHL is where the best prospects seem to come out of. Because of the competition, the passion, the desire, and all those things that are necessary to be successful in the NHL.
So, Dale, let's talk about your team. You're finally getting some bodies back, healthy lineup. Do you have a magical run like you had last year to make it in the playoffs?
Well, we have to. I think it's, I don't know about something about the starts in Florida. Yeah. Get the guys off the beach earlier, get them ready in training camp. But, you know, it's just a freaky thing that happened last year and this year as well with injuries. And, you know, we lost our goalie the first game. We lost Trocheck, our second best center. Sure. And now we've got some young guys in the lineup. Hauerluck's in the lineup, giving it Bjorkstrom. We've got McCaution and Brown now. We put in the lineup the last three games, playing with some desire, some physicality, some passion. And getting Trocheck back, that puts everybody in the right slot. And so now we've got a good complement of forwards along with D.
All right, so you love the CHL. You said last time he was here, he was watching me play.
That's the last time I think I was in this building.
Long time ago. You get around to a lot of rinks
is my favorite part of the job. Going to these rinks, seeing the people, seeing the passion of the fans and the kids' desire to play at the next level. This is what it's all about for me. I love every second of it. I love to feel it gives you your passion back for the game.
You're right, though. Awesome. The last time you were here was watching him. That was before some of these guys were born or the same year. Sorry, not
it was before the internet. Hey. Yeah, you had to come once. You couldn't look me up on the internet.
Well, thanks so much for stopping by and all
my
the best
pleasure.
For
great.
The rest of the season.
Enjoy it.
Luck,
thank Dale. You.
Well, CIBC, for the love of the fans, recognizes the passion shared by all members of the CHL community that fill arenas night after night. Let's go down to Rob Faults.
Pleased to be joined by the president of the Canadian Hockey League, Commissioner of the Ontario Hockey League, David Branch. And we talk about CIBC and the love of the fans. I think one of the things you're most proud of is the relationship each one of your franchises has with their community.
Oh, huge. And yes, it is something we're proud of, Rob. And I mean, we've always been of the belief that the key to having a successful franchise is for the community to feel they own it. It's theirs. And you strive to make and create that culture, and it's amazing how communities embrace our teams, our players, our game, and it's a great happening.
What I find fascinating is you've got all these young players, many of them leaving home for the first time, but very much willing to get involved, go to schools and reach the young kids, go to hospitals and be part of the community, really try to tie themselves in.
A huge part of it. Just yesterday, we were doing a special thing with a seniors residence with Sherwin-Williams, and there was three Red Deer Rebel players there. I watched these young guys, and they went, it was lunchtime, they sat at the tables, talked to the people, and afterwards I said, hey guys, that's outstanding. I got to thank you. And they said, oh, Mr. Branch, we got to thank these people. They support us, and this is something we should do. And I mean, the level of maturity, the understanding of putting back, fabulous.
It's a real tip of the hat to the people in the Canadian Hockey League, not only the franchises, but the players who are playing it. Dave, always great to see you.
Thank you, Rob.
Dave Branch with the Canadian Hockey League, and he's enjoying this game between Team Cherry and Team Orr after 40 minutes of play. From the Centrium in Red Deer, Alberta, the Sherwin-Williams CHL NHL Top Prospects Game, Team Cherry leading by two.
Your work never really stops. The jobs may change with the seasons, but the need for power, performance, and affordability doesn't. Right now, it's the perfect time to get a great price on durable, quality Kubota equipment. Upgrade your landscaping, construction, or farming equipment and attachments, and get what you need for the months ahead, because work never stops, and neither does Kubota. See your local Kubota dealer today.
Sherwin-Williams Top Prospect Scouting Report. Color commentary on this year's players to watch.
The first overall pick in the 2016 WHL Draft has exceeded expectations for the Kootenai Ice. After being named captain in his second season, Peyton Krebs is top 20 in WHL scoring.
Far side, Krebs. Wrist shot, scores!
Smart with or without the puck, the Okotoks, Alberta native is a complete all-around pass-first center whose hockey IQ is through the charts.
Krebs moving it across, shot scored! A great saucer pass by Peyton Krebs.
Ranked 8th among North American skaters by Central Scouting, he is most likely going to be selected in the first round of the upcoming 2019 NHL Draft. Here's Peyton with Rob.
You got an important goal for Team Cherry. Are you enjoying this experience?
Yeah, I know, it's fun. Good pass by Robbie there. It's a good play. Just tap in. That's what I like to see.
You know, I asked some of the other players about this. This is an opportunity to play with guys you don't normally see. How long does it take to get comfortable, know where they're going to be, and what you can do with them?
Yeah, you just try to prepare as much as you can before to have some fun out here. Just play hard, and that's all you can do. If you can do that, then pucks will go your way, and it'll work out in the end.
Two-goal lead right now. What's the key?
Just have some fun out there. That's all we can do. Work hard and just put some more pucks on net.
You must be having fun. You already got speared by a guy on your own bench. Enjoy.
Thanks, Matt.
Peyton Krebs of the Kootenay Ice. And right now he has the third goal. It is 3-1 Team Cherry as we head into the third period with RJ and Sam.
You couldn't see it, Rob, but in the background that was Michael Vukojevic and Thomas Harley having some fun. Big smiles trying to get into the shot.
Look at that Krebs family. You got Dakota playing in the Calgary. His brother Drew's a second-round pick at Medicine Hat. And his sister Madison, a country star.
Yeah, they're a talented family. This is a power play for Team Orr to start the third period. They need a goal. Also, another note with Peyton Krebs. He's a fitness freak. Loves to work out. He's a big fan of Rich Froning and Matt Fraser. So those CrossFit fans out there, they know those are two of the fittest men on earth. That's the title you get when you win the CrossFit Games.
You're standing next to one.
He didn't mention your name.
No. Undercover.
30 seconds to go in the power play. Here comes Team Orr. Ryan Suzuki drops it off for Josh Williams. They're both on three-game point streaks with their respective teams. Barry and Edmonton. Suzuki the shot. That's wide of the net. And comes all the way out to center ice, and this will leave Orr with not much time on this power play. Here's Tomasino. Hard wrist shot. Taylor Gauthier might have got a piece of it with that right-handed catching glove. Power play is over. No shots on that power play for Team Orr.
Yeah, a couple of misses. We've seen Leeson miss a couple of times. We saw a power play miss there. The opportunities have been there for Team Orr, just to kind of get the sights set a little better.
Puck turned over. Here's Jameson Reese. Leg RA. Can't stick handle his way around Lassie Thompson. Reese chases after this one. It'll be kept in by Billy Constantino. Kirby Dach has to retreat with the puck. Peltier has it now. He has to take a couple of steps back. And Leg RA knocked it away from Peltier. That's Moncton against Bay Como, and those two of the top-ranked QMJHL players, and that was almost a steal for Leg RA.
Yeah, playing really hard in this game on all three zones, and Peyton Krebs, big Sidney Crosby fan. You know, these kids today, they're watching YouTube, and you can get on YouTube and check out Sidney Crosby. He pointed us to this video here, and the hands are unreal.
So are Graham Clark's. Another chance. He was up against both defensemen, decided to pass. Usually it's a good idea if you're outnumbered to pass, but we saw Graham Clark deke through a few Team Cherry players and get the lone Team Orr goal. Krebs over to Robertson. He's been the playmaker, but that was a great shot. Kaliev followed up. Now he's in front of the net and he scores. Krebs sets up Arthur Kaliev, his second of the game. It's 4-1 Team Cherry.
Pure brilliance for this line. They've accounted for three of the four Team Cherry goals, and everyone gets in on the act in this particular rush. Good job coming up ice here by Peyton Krebs. Gets it to the middle of the ice, and the shot by Robertson is simply brilliant. Why? Low left pad, that creates the rebound that keeps the play alive. And once the play is kept alive, Krebs does a nice job waiting for Kaliev to get into position, and like we said before, if he gets it anywhere near the net, you may as well light it up.
So for Kaliev, that's his third point. He's ranked number 11 in Central Scouting. Krebs, his second point. He's ranked number 8. But how about Nick Robertson. Yeah. He's ranked number 30. And he's got 3 points in this game. That might change. There's a chance for Alexandrov, and Gauthier was able to get enough of his body in front of it and find that loose puck in his crease and cover it.
You know, talk to Richard Mavichuk, the head coach for the Prince George Cougars, about the fine play of Gauthier as you look at Robertson on the bench. Boy, what an evening for this guy. Two absolutely brilliant passes and then working hard on the rush there. And an unselfish player. A guy whose game's really evolved over the course of this year. I thought he handled the puck a lot in that Hlinka-Gretzky Cup. But much fine distributing work here.
Phil Tomasino gets a steal. Went for the glove side. These Timor players just getting used to the fact they're shooting on a goaltender who catches with his right hand. It was fun talking to Taylor. And how many times shooters don't even realize they go to that what they think is a blocker side, and he steals it with a glove.
Yeah, played some baseball as a catcher. A right-handed catcher is a real oddity, but that's what made his glove hand so good.
Goalie, catcher, that makes sense.
Oh, yeah. Get in front of it.
That part of it. Look at Byram. Smoothly into the team or end. But here comes Ryan Suzuki. He's by himself. Catching up is Lee. Pass was off a skate and went wide of the net. Lee with the Seattle Thunderbirds hasn't scored a lot this year, but he sensed a chance there and jumped into the play. Here comes Timor again. Williams is stopped. Puck will bounce to the blue line. Thompson thought he got there in time. He did not, and brought it in offside.
Ryan Suzuki plays for the Barrie Colts of the Ontario Hockey League, and a good opportunity to get it to Jake Lee. And the one thing that Dale Hawerchuk, his coach, says is we'd love him to shoot more. Look at how low he is. It's just he and the goalie right there. He's at the faceoff dot, and he really is looking with his hips turned sideways. You know he's going to pass there. He's not going to load it up. Shoot the puck.
That's a tough one in a game like this. You want to show you're unselfish. But in that case, that was a good look at it, Sam. Looks like he had a pretty good lane there. Every player on Team Cherry has a shot in this game except Valentin Nussbaumer. He's out there now, number 65. Plays with Shewinigan. There's Jake Lee. End of his shift. Just sent it into Team Cherry end. Vukojevic gets around Pelche, and he spotted the open man. It was Thomas Harley, the defenseman. Brett Leeson up ahead to Kirby Dach. This might be considered the best line for Team Orr. Look at Pelche comes in. Beautiful goal. Jacob Pelche brings Team Orr to within two.
Pelche's former coach in Moncton is Darren Rumble, and said this guy really drives the play. He thrives on a high compete level, and knowing that they're down 3-1 or by three goals really takes matters into his own hands. And what's interesting here is with Vukojevic and Harley up on the play, it was Kaliev who was back, so he was in good position. But the hands were simply brilliant by Pelche to get it by Kaliev, and then oh, simple, oh, so subtle between the legs to pick up the Orr goal.
That's a goal scorer there.
Oh,
no
yeah.
Problem for Pelche. You kind of knew that Doc, Leeson, Pelche, it'd be tough to keep them off the board in this game. They're still out on the ice, and Leeson knocks it just inside the Cherry blue line. Matthew Robertson up ahead to Krebs. Quick touch pass. And this would have to be the big line for Team Cherry, the way they've been going in the game. Counted for three of the goals. Connor McMichael. He and Nathan Legare have been the two faceoff leaders. Just another intangible in this game. Kaliachuk, a shot. Gauthier made that save. Graham Clark kicked immediately by Bull Duke. Guskov was there, attempted to keep it in, but here come Team Cherry. Tchaikovic in front to Zaitsev, trying to set him up and score in front of his home crowd. Here's the Red Deer Rebel. Zaitsev front of the net to Poulin. Long shot. Ellis, he looks comfortable in there for Team Orr. Just turned that to the corner. Poulin tried to center it. This will come to the blue line. Byram looking at the net. He's on his backhand side. Couldn't shoot. Here's Tchaikovic. Front of the goal. He knew Zaitsev was nearby. They did not connect. McMichael. That was some hard work just to get to his own blue line.
RJ really impressed with the skill and the speed of this game, and it's not like the guys are letting off physically.
Low shot on Gauthier, knocks that to the corner. Tomasino quickly on it. Mutala, he's dealing with Constantino. Raphael Lavoie, he's back there helping the defenseman. Constantino lost his stick, but it stayed right there for him, and he picked it up. Mutala of the Tri-City Americans to Tomasino. Dylan Cousins steals it, got it to Lavoie, had to slow down at the blue line, and Thompson, he's well aware of Dylan Cousins and how dangerous he could be, so the defenseman up ahead to Tomasino. Mutala, right, a shot, he's double-teamed by Foote and Byron. Nolan Foote, more goals than assists. That's not a surprise. He's a great goal scorer for the Kelowna Rockets.
Excellent shot, really good release. Had a big goal in the game winner against Prince Albert and a big win for the Rockets last week.
Here's Byram. Save a little for tomorrow, Bowen Byram.
Oh, yeah.
Vancouver Giants, Prince Albert Raiders, CHL on Sportsnet tomorrow at 10:30 Eastern Time. Number one team in the CHL, those Prince Albert Raiders. Pass intercepted. Greg R.A. trying to get away from Kanayazev, and Kanayazev had that extra burst. He knew he had turned the puck over and was able to get back, prevent a chance there.
Well, Legarey plays a heavy game. He's been really good stripping pucks in this game for Team Cherry.
Williams working against Bukoyevich. Joe Carroll comes in to help out. Legarey loses it to Ryan Suzuki. Williams checked before he could shoot, and Nussbaum. He waits, rolls it into the Timor end. Getting close to the midway point of the third period. It's a two-goal game. Williams still out there. Here's Suzuki, knocks down the high pass. No shot. Taliaf, 3 points. Puts it near the net. Fulton Ellis gets an arm on that. Taliaf's quickly in on the forecheck. Elchey leaves it for a hot shoot. Aliyev winds up with a puck. Krebs was yelling for it. He was going to the front of the net. Leeson checked him. Krebs knocked down right back up. Holduk to his defense partner Matthew Robertson. Long shot. Ellis saw it all the way. Kirby Dach wraps it around the glass. Leeson chips it out to center ice. Here's Robertson. The defenseman, Matthew. Peyton Krebs. Backhand saucer pass to Bolduc, and Krebs went to the net, redirected it just wide. Puck comes to the front of the goal, bounces over the stick of Krebs. Leeson's been out there a while. He'll stay out there. Kolyachanik puts it on his stick. Leeson, middle of the ice.
What a good spin there for that Team Cherry line with Kaliev and Robertson and Krebs. A lot of good zone time, a couple of good chances created.
10 minutes, 32 seconds to go in the third period, and it's Team Cherry leading by two here in Red Deer. Welcome back to Red Deer. It's the Sherwin-Williams CHL NHL Top Prospects Game. We are in Red Deer, Alberta. These are the top draft-eligible players in the Canadian Hockey League. Team Cherry in red, Team Orr in white. It's a Team Cherry 4-2 lead, third period. Max Chaikovich checked as he got to his own blue line. Matvei Guskov over to Graham Clark. He's got Connor McMichael up ahead, so he sends the puck in. Bolduc looked up, saw Guskov there, had to get rid of the puck. Here's Matvei Guskov. London Knights trying to hook up with his Knights teammate. Connor McMichael. Oleg Zaitsev was tracked down by McMichael. Bolduc chips it past McMichael. Goes and gets it himself, and then he loses it, and Clark comes in. Clark waiting, stick handling, waiting, passes, and that gave Poulin time to get back and make a great defensive play. Clark had more time than he had imagined, and too many options too.
Yeah, he wanted to be the unselfish player there, but you're in that position, you shoot it like Clark, let it go.
Leaf ends on that shot. Another great opportunity for Team Orr, and don't get anything out of it. Chaikovich, he lets Lee slide by, rolls it down to the net, and Ellis knocks it all the way to the blue line. Constantino follows up. The defenseman's behind the goal now. He centers it. Here's Dylan Cousins. He can walk right in. Put it off the side of the net. Ellis got a piece of it, scrambling to get back in his net. And the post comes off. Chances in both ends, but it's still Team Cherry leading 4-2. We'll take another break and get back to Randy. One of the memories a lot of us have of the Sherwin-Williams Top Prospects game is Don Cherry coaching, Bobby Orr coaching, and the loser handing over the $100 bill. So the coaches, they're doing a great job. Ron McLean with Team Cherry, Kelly Rudy with Team Orr. So let me ask you, Ron, because your team's ahead. Is anything on the line between you and Kelly tonight?
We don't have the kind of money that Don and Bobby have, obviously. So we had to come up with something else. So we sat at a little pub here called The Vat, and we created the idea that whoever wins, the loser must wear the sweater of the Western Hockey League team that represents the victor. So in this case, Kelly would be on Hockey Night in Canada next week in a Red Deer Rebel sweater. Colby Armstrong would love it. Brent Sutter would love it.
Wow. That's just plain old cruel, Ron.
Yeah.
Well, Kelly, you got to fire your guys up. You still have time.
We're still in it. We're playing well. We have a lot of chances lately. So this game is not over.
Two-goal game. Thank you, Kelly. Thank you, Ron. Pass intercepted by Raphael Lavoie. Here's Byram. Moves it back to Constantino. Those two are getting some pretty good chemistry as defense partners. Both great skaters. It's Constantino's turn to make a rush. Good pad save by Ellis. He has to shut the door now for Timor. They're down by two. Time's winding down. Alexandrov, he was ahead of the play and offside this time.
Yeah, pretty good performance here as you look at Sasha Mutala of the Tri-City Americans playing for Kelly Buchberger, and the guy whose game is really starting to evolve now. You see, this has got a big body guy, can play a heavy style of game, working on the skating, thinks the game well, gives a good effort on a nightly basis for the Americans.
So did I understand that right? The loser has to wear a Red Deer Rebels jersey, or is that medicine hat Ron would have to wear, I suppose?
Yeah, that's okay. What it sounds like to me.
Yep, that makes sense. Otherwise, that'd be a win-win for Ron.
Oh, yeah.
From Red Deer.
Well, maybe he orchestrated that.
Kelly wouldn't fall for that. Here's Jameson Reese. Wide open. Slap shot from Vukojevic. Might have been looking for a redirect at the back door. Miss. Ohatiu. Looks nothing but red sweaters of Team Cherry back there. Joe Carroll. Slow start for him with the Greyhounds. He admittedly was thinking a lot about the draft, but he's heating up now. Perfect time for Sault Ste. Marie. Williams behind the net. Skates away from Vukojevic. Tried to move it back to the blue line. Oh, Hotchick was not there. He's got it now. Team Cherry, a quick change. Michael Vukojevic marks the shot. Krebs can't reach the pass. Leeson intercepted it. Long reach of Arthur Kaliev. Knocked it away from the dangerous Brett Leeson.
Well, there's Peyton Krebs playing with the Kootenai Ice. And, you know, he's an amazing story in that you think about all that's gone on this year. He's been named captain as a young player. He's in a market that's suspected to be moving. A lot of trades have happened with the Kootenai Ice. And then you have the draft year to think about. And this guy has handled it beautifully.
7 minutes to go, third period. Matthew Robertson up ahead to Nick Robertson. 3 points in the game for both Kaliev and Nick Robertson. Pelche, he's scored. Jake Lee, his shot, and Kirby Dach was walking right in. In fact, the light went on. It did not go in the net. Dach missed. Thompson's shot is blocked, and Al Robertson quickly banks it off the boards. By himself, takes a look behind. He saw Lee closing in. Tried the shot, the puck stuck on him, and he didn't make contact.
Yeah, you know, he was tired chasing that puck down. Didn't have the speed to break away there. Just docked tired at the end of the shift.
Jake Lee has had an interesting game for Timor. 2 goals this year with the Seattle Thunderbirds, but boy, he's jumped to the net a few times. He's had some offensive chances, and he's done his thing defensively, too. Case in point on Nick Robertson right there.
And that's exactly what Matt Odette wants to see in Seattle. Bring that two-way game to the Thunderbirds.
Pass into the skates of Chaikovic. Kicked it ahead. Kanaev, he's under pressure again. Constantino keeps it in just barely. He was right on the blue line, right on the edge of it. Kanaev turns it over to Poulin. He takes the shot. Ellis the first save. There's a rebound, and Team Cherry's on it. Zaitsev back to the blue line. Constantino, a couple of head fakes. Trying to find that lane, but Kuzkov never gave him one. Pass ahead to Clark. Bounced off his stick, and the sure-handed Bowen Byram backs up with it. But Clark, he read it well, got a stick on it, couldn't fully steal it, though.
Amazing, just keeping your stick on the ice. What it can do at times, you just have to poke it, get it in the lane, and Byram kept going back, trying to open up that lane. Clark couldn't give it to him.
Mutala, checked by Cousins. Here comes Sasha Mutala, under 5 minutes to go. Mutala chips it to the front of the net. The puck just keeps finding him on this shift. Alexandrov centers it. There's a quick shot, a better save from Gauthier. Another backhand in there. Gauthier makes another stop, and he gets the glove on it. Team Orr, they're trying to get this puck past Gauthier. It has not been easy. Think back to last year, Aiden Dudas, Owen Sound attack. He was injury replacement late, had a great game, and all of a sudden scouts started paying a lot more attention to him. He went in the fourth round of the Los Angeles Kings. Nick Robertson is currently ranked number 30 among North American skaters, so he's not as far off the charts as Dudas was, but his performance in this game is going to garner a lot of attention over the last few months.
Yeah, he's been brilliant. He's been smart. He's been in good position. He's distributed the puck well, and when he hasn't had the chance to distribute it, he's been able to create chances by putting it off a pad or putting it into a good safe area. So I've really loved what Nick Robertson's brought to the table. An amazing story, born 3 months early and almost died as a baby.
Isn't that something? He can persevere, that's clear, and he's come into this game and he's making a name for himself, and his teammate Hunter Jones in goal, he was great. So the Peterborough Petes, they'll probably see quite a few scouts over the next few months.
Look at those two guys. Oh yeah, we played together 4 or 5 times now, all is good. Krebs is sitting there saying, yeah, I'll hang out with you guys, no problem.
And it's not to say those two on the line won't garner attention, but they were ranked quite a bit higher than Robertson coming into this game.
Yeah.
Here's Team Orr. There's another shot on goal. Carroll got the shot. Gauthier, he hasn't budged in that net for Team Cherry. Prince George Cougar goaltender. Team played last night, lost in overtime, and he was telling us this morning, wished he could have been there. Wow, there's a long shot from Nikita Ohachuk. How about that? There's 4 minutes to go. Team Orr is within one.
It's interesting, RJ, when Gauthier came into the game, you talked about all the shots that ended up on his glove side because, hey, players don't see him very much, so they were shooting to the glove side. Well, not in this particular occasion. Ohachuk from the Ottawa 67s does a good job to force that screen to come into play. And when he does so, ends up putting it on goal with some good accuracy. And Gauthier simply misses it on the blocker side. We're into a one goal game.
You just never know in this game. Nikita Ohachuk has one goal with Ottawa this season. And he scored. Valentin Nesquam has to turn. Here's Robertson jumping into the play. Ellis sets imperative that he made that save for Team Orr just after they crept to within one. They don't want to be down by two again. Horton Ellis, Romanowski Oceanic, the lone Maritimer in this game.
Sometimes it's not how many you make, but when you make them, and that was a timely save for Ellis.
Jake Lee battles Attempted steal, and here's Leeson walking right in. Leeson scores. Brett Leeson has tied the game. Team Orr's on a roll.
So many chances afforded Leeson in this game, but you can only keep a guy of his talent level, of his production abilities off the board for so long. And a great job here as Leeson picks up that puck off the skate of Matthew Robertson, the Edmonton Oil Kings defenseman. And as Robertson tried to get back into position, he blew a tire. The big right shot with that long reach extends Gauthier to the glove side and ends up burying it to tie this hockey game. A couple of quick strikes by Team Orr.
There's a timeout for Team Cherry. So it's two goals in 46 seconds, and that two-goal lead we were talking about is gone.
Oh, yeah, they're loving it on the bench. Kelly Rudy's thinking, oh, I'm going to get my Tigers jersey ready for Ron. Well, a bit of a timeout just to get things reset a little bit. But, you know, the first 10, 12 minutes of the game really owned by Team Cherry, and then Team Orr started to find its stride. Really good final 8 minutes of that first period, came out with some good energy, good momentum in that second period, and they've just stuck with it. They've played a patient game here and have leaned on some of the heavyweights down the stretch here to get them back into a tie game.
3 minutes and 15 seconds to go in regulation time.
Kelly's loving it over there on the bench.
Hey, he stayed positive.
He did.
He had a feeling down there that there was more to come from Team Orr. He's right. Graham Clark, long shot. Oh, it's loose in front, and Guskov didn't get there in time. The momentum all on Team Orr right now. Here's Artemi Knyazev. Leaves it for Connor McMichael. He scores. That's three quick ones, and all of a sudden, Team Orr leads.
Connor McMichael of Team Orr plays for the London Knights in the Ontario Hockey League, and he's having a fantastic season for Dale Hunter. 27 goals on the year, and Knyazev does a great job stopping. That creates gap, and when that gap opens up, McMichael jumps into it. You can see him trailing the plays, waiting, looking up, accepts the pass, and he buries it. How about Team Orr with this late surge, and now it's Team Cherry on its heel.
That is three goals in a minute and 12 seconds. Wow, that has changed everything here in Red Deer. Team Orr, they had so many chances. A couple open nets just missed. A couple of one-timers in front of the goal looked like open nets. They just weren't connecting, and now everything's going right. Perfect time for it. Nikita Ahatyuk. One goal with Ottawa, one goal in this game. He was feeling it. He was trying to make it two goals.
How about RJ when it was 4-3 for Team Cherry? Colton Ellis makes that save.
Yes.
And that turned everything around. That gave Orr all the momentum to come back and quick strike three times.
That's a great point. Here's Poulin. Drops it off. Sights have checked. And Team Orr. They're feeling good. And here they come again. Alexandrov. Pass off a skate. R.C. Thompson steals it. The Kelowna Rockets defenseman just whistles that high. Now Team Cherry, they've got to start thinking about pulling the goalie. There's minute 40 to go. They're down a goal. Team Cherry trailing for the first time in the game. Ryan Suzuki, he's skating well. The Barry Colt narrowly missed. He's from London, Ontario. Here's Joe Carroll from Carp, Ontario. Bolduc reaches in. Can't take the puck away from him. Suzuki, a quick pass. Bolduc reaches for it. He and Carroll, they've been engaged in a few puck battles on this ship. Bolduc now has to deal with Josh Williams. Team Orr's okay having the puck down there. They're up a goal now. Hayden Korzan rolls it deep. Hopes those forwards can keep doing that great work. There's under a minute to go in the third period. Back at the blue line. There's a shot that's wide of the goal. Korzak comes over. He had to take a hit from Nolan Foote, his Kelowna Rockets teammate. Not icing. Josh Williams, top of the circle, snaps a shot. Wide of the goal. Pelche sprinted to that puck to keep it inside the Team Cherry end. They've got it now, and Gauthier wants to join his team up the ice and get to the bench. Not yet. Now he goes. 20 seconds to go. Extra attacker just getting into the play now. Kolyachanik, the Flint Firebird defenseman, plays it off the boards, got it to center ice. Byram's pass. That's the foot. It's stolen. There's the empty net. Wide of the goal. Byram drops it behind. There's not going to be enough time, it appears. There won't be. Puck was intercepted by Peltier. There's 1.9 seconds to go. This picture-perfect play of the game is brought to you by Walmart, photocenter.ca. Preserve your journey.
Well, how about Team Moore with a mighty comeback here late in the third period? It all starts with the Ottawa 67's defenseman Nikita Ohotyuk with his first of the game. And then Brett Leeson had so many good chances early on. Ends up getting around Taylor Gauthier. And then Connor McMichael from Grant Park and Artemi Knyazev ends up capping off the scoring and the win for Team Moore.
All it was a drop of the puck. That was it. Game is over, and Team Orr did not lead for long. Didn't matter. They led at the right time, and they win the game. Kelly wins the bet with Ron McLean, so it looks like Ron on Saturday will be wearing a medicine hat sweater.
Isn't that interesting? But what a great display of skill we saw in this game. The speed, the skill, it looks a lot like what we're seeing in the NHL. This game here mirrors what we're seeing in the NHL. Play fast, make plays in tight spaces, and continue to show off the skill and the speed of the game. What a wonderful display all night long by both teams.
Fastest goal to start a game, that was scored by Arthur Kaliev 56 seconds in. A couple of two-goal leads, in fact, a three-goal lead for Team Cherry, but Team Orr hung around and they scored when it mattered. That line of Kaliev, Robertson, and Krebs was really, really good for Team Cherry, and for the most part was the story until the last few minutes in that goal surge from Team Orr.
Yeah, so you saw one line with all the heavy lifting for Team Cherry, and you saw things distributed more evenly for Team Orr with getting four different goal scorers, starting with Clark, Peltier, Ohotyuk, Leeson, and McMichael. Five different goal scorers for Team Orr in this game.
Players shake hands. So many of them know each other through international events or the same league or growing up together. And this was an important event for these players, no question about it. They all want to play, be one of the 40 players invited to the Sherwin-Williams CHL NHL Top Prospects game. It's just on that list of that draft year for these players. It's a game they want to play in. They want to showcase their skills against their peers. It was a good game here in Red Deer. A lot of players helped themselves up their stock. Team Orr, a great comeback late with three goals in a minute and 12 seconds to win the game. Team Orr beats Team Cherry in the Sherwin-Williams CHL NHL Top Prospects game here in Red Deer. Sportsnet Central with Eric and Carly is next.